flip back and forth to this on this part. Get that Muscogee up, please. We didn't do it. Hey, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Lakewood Stadium. We are getting our brains all set up and ready to go, which is exciting across the board here. I'm Bo McMichael with Score Sports, bringing you the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic. Yes, I'm going to get that through in and out of my brain constantly. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon's kickoff is going to see the South Fulton All-Stars versus the Muscogee County All-Stars. And with the kick, the game is starting whether we like it or not. We got two announcers here today going to bring the game to you live and in color. That'll be Craig Chapman and Adam Collins. Gentlemen, I'll let you take it away so I can figure out what's falling in the sky right now because I'm Chicken Little. Glad to have everybody with us. Hand it over, gentlemen. Take it away. We'll be back with you right around halftime.
Well, it looked like there was going to be a big hole right there in the middle. It closed up fast. Good kickoff coverage right there by Muscogee County.
Yes, it was. Yes, it was. I was thinking the same thing, that our lead-in was going to be a 90-yard kickoff return for a touchdown.
Because there was a ton of space. Right now, the Muscogee defense, I'm interested to see what that D-line looks like. Rumor has it all four of those guys are going to sign.
Yeah, Coach Baker was pretty complimentary of them.
And there's our first flag. And illegal substitution.
We got 12 on the field.
Yeah, I will say it's easier to play with 12. I've actually had a team drive the field on us, and we had 12 out there. And I was thinking to myself, if we can't stop them with 12 people, what are the chances with 11? All right.
Yeah, first and 15.
South Fulton lines up, just in the I formation, just a pro I look. Give right there on the outside ISO. And it is swallowed up. That D-line is allowing nothing to happen.
Gain a 2 on the play right there.
Tell you what, defensively, if you got cats up front that can soak up blocks and it lets those linebackers run free, it sure does make playing defense easy.
Mm-hmm. One of the best things about playing linebackers is if you're clean. And if you're clean and you can go hunt, that makes your job a whole lot easier. Coach, you want to talk about the rules for the game so everybody that's watching will understand exactly what we got here?
Well, basically everything's live with the exception of punt. And the punt return is live, and they just broke the huddle with 12 again.
Let them go.
Anyway, gun look, just pro right gun. Quarterback waits on the snap. There's a snap. He drops, looks to his left.
Got the post.
Lets it fly. Oh, that should have been picked. That should have been picked. He never saw the safety.
Pass broken up by number 14 right there.
He never saw the safety. Back to the rules. Punt is not live, but punt return is. And I know that sounds insane. But basically, you cannot rush the punt, but the punt is going to be returned. Which, to me, makes these games far more entertaining than one where, you know, only scrimmage kicks are live.
I agree.
Sorry about that. Turn, I got you.
Getting the technical support here.
Yeah. Technical support. Is that what you call it?
That's what I said.
All right. Looking at third and long right here. That's never a good sign. Doubles look. Quarterback in the gun, back offset to his right side. Doesn't look like they're going to send any heat. I don't think you can. Motion coming from left to right. There's a snap. Quarterback almost takes a knee.
Wheel route.
Lets it fly down the sideline. He's got a man. He makes a man miss, and he's cleaned up right there at the end by pursuit. Like, he almost knelt down trying to field that snap, which is always one of the big challenges in a game like this. To me, the center quarterback exchange is just vital.
That was a 39-yard pickup on third down and 13, Coach.
Third down and 13 and 39-yard pickup?
Yes.
So, South Fulton has new life. That doubles look again. Dance with the one I brung you, yeah, I guess.
Looks like cover 3.
Motion. give on the jet right there coming around the left side. Lots of holding going on. And no doing right there. Nice play made by, I believe he's a corner right there, number 21.
Loss of six on that completion. So you get plus 39 on the second pass and minus six on the third.
Well, they started minus five with the penalty down there the first time, so.
Got them right where they want them.
That's right. 39-yard play coming up.
Here it is.
Wrote a song about it. Want to hit?
Here you go.
Here you go. Okay. Trips to the field right here. Tall single receiver to the boundary right here. I wonder if that's where they're going. Quarterback in the gun. There's a snap. Nope, he rolls right. He's looking, dumps it off, and that's going to go incomplete. The receiver out there looked surprised that the ball came to him.
Yeah, it was like, hey, why are you throwing it to me?
Yeah, I'm standing here by myself. No, don't throw it to me. Reminds me of that scene from The Simpsons where Milhouse is in the backfield and Bart's the quarterback, and Milhouse is like, God, please no, Bart.
So the second, third, and long of the first drive right here. So far you've got – this will be the sixth play of the drive. It's covered right now, you know, 37 yards.
They just broke with 12 again.
And we're going to get a timeout.
They broke with 12 again, and so they took a timeout.
Smart.
That is the third time.
Yes.
They've broken the huddle with 12.
One time they just lined up with 12, Coach.
You know, organization has got to be really tough in games like this because you're trying to communicate with people that don't necessarily know what your plan is. You know, whereas with your own team, you know, you probably have personnel groupings and you have names for those things, and it's really easy because everybody knows it because, you know, you work on it 5 days a week and, you know, sometimes six, depending if you're off or not.
Yep.
But, you know, to pull a group of guys together, although they did have, what, 4 days mm-hmm. to work together, which is a real plus in a game like this. But the more organized you can be, the better off you are. It actually can, you know, turn into points. Simply getting the right people on the field, right people on and off the field, I guess I should say. So, all right, here we go. Back to action. Trips to the field. Twins to the bottom side. Empty set. Quarterback in the gun. Here comes the rush. He's got plenty of time. Able to stand back, survey the field. Pulls the ball down. Comes back to his
left.
Lets it fly. And just out of the reach right there of number Tri-Cities. I can't see. He will not turn where I can see his jersey. He's still walking.
Looks like number 88.
88. Okay, there we go. Tony Gonzalez.
Number 14 got his hands on it again.
That guy's been kind of hot so far.
Mm-hmm. So get your first punt of the game.
I think we're missing some people.
What, recruiting on a special team? Never happens.
That's always the thing. You got too many on for offense and can't get enough out for punt team.
Well, nobody wants to be on the punt team, man. Yeah, don't you know that?
Everybody's moving. And there's the kick. And it bounces.
Uh-oh.
And it's picked up.
I think they forgot.
This is interesting. There's two blocks in the back. Hey, there's the flag.
There it is.
But look, what looked like was going to be really good field position. Because it appeared as if everyone was confused about what was going on. Because that is difficult. You're not supposed to rush. And I guess, you know, I know a lot of teams rush the punter every play. Every time there's a punt, they rush the punter. You know, you got to be prepared to play what we call Jesse James right there.
Mm-hmm.
And just hold everybody up and try to return like that. Because you can't rush the kick, but the ball can be returned. And it almost looks like the referees are confused about how this is supposed to be done. Okay, there we go. So first and 10 from the 27, I think they just said. And that's what it appears to be from here. Our first look at the Muscogee County O and that South Fulton D. There's a snap. Give on the jet around the right side, but it is stuffed. Young man from Westlake right there stuffed that. Is that 94?
It is.
Nice play by number 94 for South Fulton. I don't think that Muscogee will struggle with exchanges. I noticed a lot of similar helmets up front.
Yes.
The entire right side from the center over is the same color as the quarterback's helmet.
Minus three on first down right there, Coach.
There's a snap. Give on the zone. He cuts back to his left and can find no footing.
They're going to give him that 3 yards back.
Bring up third down and 10. All right. So, big play right here for Muscogee. The last thing you want to do is just give the ball back.
Third and 10 right here. Going to be trips, Coach.
Trips to the field. Single receiver to the boundary right there.
Looks like we got a cover two look.
There's a snap. Quarterback drops. Comes back. Good gravy.
He caught that.
Caught.
First down.
Came out of the quarterback's hand funny and just kind of flipped around in the air, but was brought down by – I didn't see a number right there.
It was caught by number five.
By number five. There we go. Number five, Caleb Bailey.
27-yard pickup for a first down.
So, doubles. There's the snap. Looks like a false start to me.
They got a good jump on the right side right over here.
Yeah. I guess the referees are being kind of liberal.
Gain of two is going to bring up second and eight right here, right at midfield.
Doubles looks like going to be the choice again for Muscogee. Number four, Jalen Joyner, waiting on the snap. There it is. He drops, looks to his right, going pumps deep. It, lets it fly.
Broken up.
Apparently, somebody's got a bad – the DBs have a bad case of the brick hands today because that's the second pick there should have been. That, you know, got volleyball spiked onto the ground.
Did you see what number broke that up, Coach?
That would have been a big turnover. I'm trying to see. Those black jerseys with the green numbers kind of hard to read, Coach.
And then you can't see it on the back because he's got his back flap up.
Yeah, everybody's jersey's rolled up.
So third and eight right here.
Basically a doubles look again with that wing to the right side.
Screen.
They try to get him the ball on the tunnel screen. He comes back through. Big pickup by number 15 right there. Jarius Thomas, ball delivered by Jalen Joyner.
Gain of 11 and another first down.
And unfortunately, it looks like Jarius Thomas is down. He went up, and it looked like his legs were extended when he got popped. But hopefully this is a cramp or he's just shaking up, maybe the air knocked out of him. That's what we're hoping here. This is a great game, though. I've actually been here before, and it was a really good game that time. The Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic, you know, we get to watch not only South Fulton play Muscogee, but later today we'll get to watch APS versus Clayton.
That is true, and since we, you know, we're from Clayton, so, you know, we'll try not to be biased.
Yeah, that's awful difficult. You know, once a wild rat, always a wild rat. That's what I say. But, you know, I was looking at some of the teams, and, you know, there's some storied programs from down there in Columbus. You got Kendrick, Spencer, Carver, Hardaway, Northside, Columbus. And then, of course, you know, on the South Fulton teams that we're really familiar with, you know, having played in the Atlanta DeKalb region for a while, you know, where you got Banneker, Hapeville Charter, Creekside, Westlake, who else, Tri-Cities.
Langston Hughes.
Langston Hughes.
Creekside.
Yeah, I think we covered everybody. But
Hapeville Charter, Coach.
But a lot of really good teams.
Do we have a Jordan sighting on the Columbus on the Muscogee County? Is there a Jordan sighting?
There is.
That's where my father-in-law went to school.
It's funny because it's J-O-R-D-A-N, but we'll get back to that.
Yep.
All right, doubles look. There's snap. Thomas takes snap, drops.
Seam route.
Comes up and has the wherewithal to let it fly. I really thought he was going to run it right there. Looks like the ball one-hopped on him. Came up just short of his receiver.
I need you to hit that red button before every play. You think you can do it? Yeah, just like that. And when the play's over with, yeah. When the play's over with, you hit stop.
All right.
But the J-O-R-D-A-N, you know, just like Shug Jordan.
Mm-hmm.
Jordan Hare.
There it is.
All right, that sniffer back to the left side. Going to try to run a little power football right there. And, my goodness, they brought him back to where he came from.
Getting a one right there.
Carried by number six, Fred Davis. It's been tough sledding for the O-lines today. I'm trying to get any traction with the run game. I'm waiting on a counter. The counters have got to be coming.
Yeah, they will. Got to see, this is the feeling out process.
Leave that alone.
Oh, man.
trips to the boundary, single receiver to the right side. Just, you know, I'm imagining right now that there's a snap. Jairus Thomas takes a drop, lets it fly out to his right side, has a man with a step, but that's going to be picked. By he's going to bring it out of the end zone. He's coming down the left side, shakes a man. There's already a flag down. It looks like he might be going all the way, but it's coming back no matter what.
Oh, he fumbled. Oh, he got it back.
I mean, it bounced right back to him. Heads up play right there by number six, Fred Davis, trying to strip the ball. But that ball intercepted by number one, Malik Fleming.
And we talked about Malik pregame.
Yeah, who where is he signed to?
East Carolina.
East
Coach.
Carolina. He's already signed with East Carolina. So, obviously, a baller because East Carolina is a big program.
He just had a 63-yard return that's going to get wiped out.
Yeah,
it looks
there's a flag on the nine. Actually, I would say 9 5/8. 9 5/8-yard line. So that one's coming back. You know, nice return. I really thought he was going to stay in the end zone, but I was thinking, and I started going, okay, who am I kidding?
Yeah.
It's an all-star game. Nobody's staying in the end zone.
No, sir. So that'll be half the distance from the nine, so it'll put it at about the
– if you walk down there and told the kid you're going to get tackled on the four-yard line, they'd be like, nah. If all 11 guys were standing right there, I think he still brings it out of the end zone.
Yes.
The chance of glory.
Let's see where they put this at. Penalty was at the nine. They're going to put it on the four.
Just inside the five is my guess.
It's half the distance, so it should be at the four.
The four and 2 1/2/8.
And they put it. Oh, they won't either. It won't be first and 10 from the nine. It'll be from the four.
Not unless math has changed. All right, doubles look. Quarterback in the gun, standing in his own end zone. There's a snap. Oh, fumbles the snap in the end zone and has to dive out of the end zone onto the football.
Mm.
And there it is, the quarterback center exchange.
We always get a chance to talk about it, how important it is. It's not anywhere more important than when you're backed up to your own goal line. Now you went from, you know, bad field position to worse field position and you lost it down.
You know, and I've seen teams get a lot of flack. I've been part of teams that got a lot of flack about staying in the gun, in the red zone, as well as in the green zone. You know, because I like to think of the 20 going in as being the green zone as opposed to the red zone. And the red zone is actually coming out of the end zone.
Yes. That's where you can
– and now we're under center in the eye. And just a pro right, and there it is, ISO. And
gain of two.
Defense closes quickly. Pickup of about 2 yards, as you said.
I'm just going to bring up third down.
Is that number 8 or number 9 on the quarterback?
Number 9.
Number 9, Jordan Slocum out of Hapeville. Here we go. Pro right, eye. There's a snap.
Power
quarterback
pass.
Rolls to the right, lets it fly. Had a man, but just coverage was pretty good. But I thought he could have come back to the ball right there and maybe made a play on the ball. But instead, just kind of watches it sail out of bounds.
Now you're going to punt from your own end zone, Coach.
That's never a good thing, especially with the wackadoo punt rules.
Should give Muscogee County really, really nice field position right here, one way or the other.
Well, is that number 22 that's waiting at the 40?
Looks like it.
Number 22, Corey Calhoun out of Spencer, waiting at the 40-yard line on the ball. They're doing the punt team head count. And two guys run on, one guy changes his mind. Ah, punt team.
Yeah, but we got 11, Coach.
The bane of everybody. The bane of everyone's existence. There's a kick. It's a spinning kick. It's going to bounce backwards. And going to be picked up by Muscogee at about what looks to be the 30-yard line.
It's about a 23-yard punt right there, Coach. So.
What? We're having some technical issues. But I think we're just about got it done now. Got our umbrella up for the things that are falling from the sky. All right. Sniffer look again. A little power football. Going to just throw it up in there. I think that was number 11 on the carry.
Gain of 2.
That's Trey Lee. Out of Spencer. These were both pretty good games the last time I was here. If I'm not mistaken, last time I was here, we did this on Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Now, trip set to the field. Quarterback in the gun. Thomas takes a snap.
Speed out.
Lets it fly. To the left side, down the sideline. And that looked like an old-school wrestling boot scoot right there when he caught the ball.
Gain of 12 right there on the first down.
And they're not wasting any time getting reset. Doubles look for Muscogee. There's a snap. Quick give up the gut. Looks like it's going to pick up 3. That carry again by number 11, Trey Lee. All right, trips to the field again to the right side this time.
Fade.
There it is, over the top. He's got a man.
Touchdown.
That's it. He's in there. And just like that, Muscogee's on the board.
14-yard touchdown pass.
That number is a really long way away.
15, Coach.
Number 15 on the reception. Jarius Thomas.
Jarius Thomas. No, wait a minute.
Okay. Jalen Joyner is the quarterback. I've been saying Thomas. That's my bad. I got my –
Are we going to kick this thing?
I would think so. Am I drafting a kicker? It's anything like kicking it in my place. And there's a million people that swear they can kick. Everybody wants to try. The first day we say who can kick, there's 45 people that line up saying they can kick.
Mm-hmm.
But this is supposed to be live, so.
I don't think it's going to be.
No, there's certainly not a lot of posture there, is there? No. Okay.
He got it.
Yep. Yeah, because that ball kind of blooped back there, and deep snapping is an art. It's a very seldom thought of skill until you get a punt or an extra point blocked, and then you know your thoughts are give me a snap.
Mm-hmm.
So with 1:46 left in the first quarter, Muscogee County 7, South Fulton 0. But this could be the great equalizer right here in this All-Star game with the live kickoff kick return.
Yes. We saw the hole that there was last time on the South Fulton side.
If they had set up their blocks a little bit better up front, I mean, there was a huge amount of space. I really thought that he had a chance. But then the middle just closed.
It's been a pretty well-played first half or first quarter so far. With 1:46 left, it's 7-0, Muscogee County. And, you know, it's funny that they threw the interception, but that interception actually led them to the field position that allowed them to score the touchdown.
Yes.
It's a shame because there was a 63-yard return on that interception too.
Number 12, Xavier Clark, lined up to kick for Muscogee. Is that number one deep right there? That looks like a single digit, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I think that's Malik Fleming deep for South Fulton.
And we say we think because neither one of us can see, and we're on the space shuttle, you know, looking at this game. So
we do have a great vantage point, but numbers are difficult. Oh, a spiraling kick. Going to be picked up at about the 5-yard line. He's going to try to cut back, but Fleming just gets run out of bounds, and it was indeed Fleming with the ball. He gets run out of bounds at the 8-yard line.
Yes, it is.
One of the interesting things about kickoff today, and we were told this before the game started, you know, we're trying to get our bearings as far as the rules go.
Mm-hmm.
Because the rules for the regular game are usually pretty simple. You know, you have things like you can't blitz. You can only play cover 2, 3, or 0. You have to have an even man front. You know, basically you can't cover the center. But the addition to the kicking game rules, where they're going to allow them to bring it out of the end zone. So if the ball is kicked into the end zone, they can still bring it out. Here comes South Fulton. Doubles look. Quarterback in the gun. There's a snap. Quick give around the right side. A little stretch action. And no, sir. That Muscogee D is quick.
Doesn't look like you want to run wide on them.
No, sir. I don't think you do.
But that's that D-line again, getting good push, not allowing for gaps to, you know, they're maintaining gap integrity, Coach. That is a word.
Yeah, just look really sound up front. You know, and that's where it all starts. You know, you always talk about, you know, I would say down there on the field, no disrespect meant to either side, but on the hoof, South Fulton looks really, really good.
Yeah. I think we got 12 again.
Yep, he just came off. That's time number 5. There's a snap. Quarterback looks out to his right, lets it fly, has a man.
Nice job.
And he gets tossed onto the track.
Gain 9 right there. It's going to set up 3rd and manageable right here.
Good job by Caleb Dixon getting the ball out of his hands. Caleb out of Westlake. That's a long way to run every play.
It is.
But you don't exactly have time to teach signals, you know.
Wristbands, that's what they were made for.
All right. Doubles look.
Nobody's covering this guy in the slot.
Oh, my word. He's all by himself.
They're still not going to
go. Nobody's even over. They're going to bring that guy. They're running somebody over there now.
Take off.
Quarterback takes off. He's got some wheels. There he goes down the right side. I believe that's Caleb Dixon on the carry.
It is.
He's going to call his own number.
Pick up a first down. keep the drive alive.
Tell you what, that's one of my favorite things for the quarterback to do is run everybody off and then you run off.
Mm-hmm.
That's
the Mario Fannin offense. We're going to get five wide right here and everybody's going to run a go route and we're going to let Mario pick the hole he wants to run in.
It's pretty reliable if you've got a guy that can do it.
Yeah, if you got one of those guys that everybody fears, they're either going to have somebody wide open because everybody's staring in the backfield at the quarterback, or you know, you're going to get cheap yardage. Basically, is what I'm talking about.
Doubles look, gun, that little bullet look, they're right at the gut. And again, man, the closing speed. There was a nice hole over the left side where I really thought it was opened up. And, man, that Muscogee D just closes so quickly.
But in regards to this, Coach, let's just be honest. You know, as a first down play, they just gained 3 yards on first down.
Oh, yeah, I'm happy with that.
And they have been negative in the first down.
So that was quick, folks. But at the end of one, Muscogee County 7, South Fulton 0. Here live, coming live to you from the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic. Game 1 of 2, Muscogee County versus South Fulton. For you folks that are home enjoying this one, you know, you should stay with us for the rest of the day and go ahead and get ready for that Clayton APS game. That should be a really good one.
Because there is no other game coming on at 4 o'clock today that anybody would want to watch.
Nope.
Not another game.
Nope. Yeah, that college football playoff stuff, shenanigans.
Way overrated.
I know I was watching all the stuff this morning on ESPN. And
on the ESPN?
On the ESPN. On the Ocho. that's where you watch dodgeball.
No lie, the other night, Coach, I'm flipping it through the channels about 9:30, and ESPN2 had dodgeball. And I started dying laughing.
Was it the trampoline stuff?
No, it was real dodgeball, just like in the movie where they had you had to sprint to get the ball and all that. All I could think of was if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
I tell you what. Some of my favorite memories of being a PE teacher are dodgeball games. That's just watching people get hit in the head and taking off their feet and listening to the kids yell, boom, headshot.
You can't say that, Coach. You can't say that.
All right, here we go. Doubles look for South Fulton. Motion coming from right to left. Turns it up on
nice
the jet.
Cut.
Nice cut. Nicely done. Going to be a nice solid gain right there.
Gain of 5 right there.
He did the right thing. He saw a crease, and he hit the crease, and that was the difference between getting stuffed and getting 4 yards.
Brings up 3rd down and 2. That's about the closest 3rd down they've had.
Five yards then. But you got 3rd and manageable. Here's your chance to put together a drive.
So what do you think right here? What you got on 3rd and 2?
3rd and 2, and they're going to get in the pro set and just, like, pound it. That's what Coach Gordon is a pro set guy.
ISO right here, Coach?
That would be my guess. There's a snap.
Ran power.
Running off the right side. And
that's a great run. Where they're spotting it should be a 1st down.
He got it. But, again, the whole defense was just standing there waiting on him.
Wow. Nice effort right there. It was 3rd and 2, and he got 2.
He stretched it right there around the right side, and I didn't think he was going to get there, but just nice effort driving his legs, trying to get upfield. You know, so often what we see in backs is they stretch, 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 and they never turn up.
Yep.
Which is not good for you on short yardage.
Now, this drive right here is starting to take shape. I mean, if you look at their field position, South Fulton's been at the 12, the 4, and the 8. So they've got it out here, you know, got out to the 33 right now. So we've got a 25-yard drive working on 6 plays. So, you know, see if they can bust something for a little bit longer yardage right here.
There's a snap.
Quarterback
pulls it around the left side.
There it goes.
Right down the middle. And he is dangerous.
Yes, sir.
And, again, that's Caleb Dixon on the carry. I mean, he came around that edge quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Caleb Dixon with 18 and another 1st down.
And this is not South Fulton playing on a short field. This is them driving the field. Where did this drive start?
Started at the 8-yard line.
Okay, so you know, you put together a 92-yard drive, you can really feel good about things.
Mm-hmm. Right now, it's 7 plays so far, so you got a chance to eat up some time right here. It'll be interesting to see if they go back to that same look.
Dixon in gun, waiting on the snap. Doubles look. Gets pressure, just instant pressure.
Sack.
Brought down by number 99, Robert Murray out of Spencer. Part of that big Muscogee D-line.
There you go.
He was on him fast right there, buddy.
Mm-hmm. And I hate to say this, but what was looking as a promising drive, sitting at first and 10 after you'd gone from your own 8 to the 49, and now you lose 5 on first down, and, you know, you're back in that same situation again of, you know, you got to overcome your own mistake, you know.
It's really hard to be methodical when you have errors like that, because that's an error. See, like, they just didn't block it. Either that or he hit a really quick move.
Never going to get this play off.
And there's their second time out of the half. So with 8:37 left in the first half, Muscogee County 7, South Fulton 0. I tell you what, man, it's a pretty evenly matched game so far.
A lot of good plays, you know, a lot of good athletic plays being made. Shows a lot of really good speed. We've said before that there are plays that look like they're there, and then the hole closes or the space closes. On that last sack, I thought they were throwing a quick screen down here, and I don't know if it was fake the quick screen and go over the top. But, you know, if he would have let the quick screen go, it looked like they had a good chance to get 5 yards because he had a guy sitting there, you know, without press coverage. And so when he pumped it, I was thinking, why? Why are you pumping him? But it may have been, you know, I couldn't see what the other wide receiver on that side was doing. He may have been running the wheel route. I've got an obstructed view here, Coach.
Yeah, well, that, and, you know, we're sitting on top of the
– Stone Mountain?
Yeah, watching the game. We are way up here.
A bird flew by a while ago. Not a bird. It was actually a plane, but
– Yeah. Okay.
All right, here we go. Second and 15.
Okay, just a doubles look for South Fulton. They're having a tough time covering the slot, man.
Screen.
Motion came across from left to right. A little screen pass thrown out to the left side, but Muscogee was more than ready for that. That's going to bring up third and 15.
You know, Coach, I think right there, if that ball is thrown a little bit better, not that it was a bad pass, but if it would have been thrown where the receiver could come back towards the line of scrimmage, I think they had something. I like the way they blocked that. They flashed out the running back out to block the corner, put an equal person on there, and let the tackle come out and seal that linebacker. It looked like they may have had a little seam right there.
Yeah, it looked like he had something, but then when he bobbled the ball, that was pretty much the end of that.
Mm-hmm. So it's third and 15. What you got in the playbook for third and 15?
Third and 15. 60 read out of doubles. That's motion from left to right again.
Wheel route, maybe?
There's the snap. Quarterback drops, looks across the middle, has a man. Oh, and just a step away. And he pays for holding on to that one, but he hung in there and let it fly, and the receiver's just a step short.
That was just they had double post right here, and the motion guy came and ran the wheel route. And he had the second post open. Probably had to get rid of it before he wanted to get rid of it, to be quite honest with you.
Is that number 13 right there? We'll see, number 13. No, I was talking about the receiver for South Fulton. Let's see, back to return for Muscogee. If he'll turn and show me his number. That's a short kick. It's going to take a hop. Gets a good South Fulton roll. Number 18 from Muscogee was flirting with disaster right there.
43-yard punt right there, Coach.
It's one of those deals where he's standing around the pile watching the ball roll. It looked like it might could have hit him.
I wish I would have counted how far that thing rolled.
Well, on average, it'll roll 17.4 yards, Coach. Yeah,
that's right. Thank you, Scott Warner.
You know, as a coach, you know that you're standing there, you're going to catch the ball.
Please.
Catch the ball. You know, it always seems like they try to do whatever the opposite of what you say is. If you're like, just let it drop. If you have any doubt, just let it drop. And if you say you have to catch this one, they let it drop. Sniffer look. Give. My goodness. Offensive line for Muscogee looked like a sieve right there.
I think that was supposed to be some version of the zone read.
Yeah, because it looked like everybody went right for the offensive line, and then the back cut back left where there was nobody. And that's just not a good situation.
1 yard loss, so it's going to bring up second and 11. Now, it's interesting watching this. I know that they have certain stipulations on the defense, but that last down, they didn't really cover the slot again.
Quarterback drops, rolls out to his right, got a man wide open. There he goes down the sideline. Looks like he's about to break a tackle. Eventually brought down by Malik Fleming.
16 yards and a first down right there.
Who was that on the catch right here? Is that this kid running to us right now, number 10?
I thought it was the back.
Was it? There's a snap. Give off the right side.
Uh-oh.
Oh, we found some room right there. That's the thing about the run game. You know, if you can just keep going, if you can just stay true to what you do and keep pounding that run game, not only will your counters show up, but the later you're getting in the first half and then late third quarter, you really start to see those runs develop because the D-line just gets tired.
Right now, both teams have 4 first downs. The only difference right now is the score.
Quarterback in the gun, doubles. There's a snap. Lets it fly. That was a dangerous pass.
Tried to work the speed out concept over there.
I really thought that one had a chance to get snagged by the wrong side there.
It's going to bring up 3rd down and 6. Be interesting to see. I haven't seen a screen look out of Muscogee yet outside of the tunnel screen. Wonder if they got a screen to the back.
I would be willing to bet you they do. There's a snap. Quarterback drops. Throws
speed
it
out.
And it's thrown and caught. It's going. Okay, now here comes the decision.
Caught for 4 yards right there.
4th and what is that, 2?
Mm-hmm.
4th and a long 2.
Yeah, it's a long 2. Looks like they're thinking about it.
Tell you what, you haven't had a run. What do most of their runs look like? You've been keeping track of that.
Yeah, the longest run is 4. Okay, and that was the last run they just had.
What you got? 3, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, -1, 4?
Minus 2 was the first one. But they're going to go for it.
Yeah, I might gamble right here.
See if they try to draw them off sides. Then we'll call timeout.
Might want to talk about this one. I know Coach Woolridge might want to. Okay, he changed his mind. somebody on the sideline was like, hey, Coach, there's 5 minutes left. We can get the ball back, kick it to him. But, you know, you're protecting a 7-point lead, you know, going into half. You deferred.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to get the ball back.
Mm-hmm.
What you don't want to do is give South Fulton the short field.
And momentum.
Yes.
I mean, if you look at it, games change on block punts. Games change on, you know, failed fourth down conversions. Now, you know, turnovers always change games. But, you know, if you look at this game, the game changed in a positive for Muscogee County on their turnover because of a penalty. So, you know, we got all kind of, you know, different things working there.
Yeah, what would have been a short field for South Fulton turned into three and out in the short field for.
Mm-hmm. All right, we're going to punt this thing from the 37.
All right, here we go. There's a snap. Oh, my word. Ball picked up by number 12. But
ball. Uh-oh.
That's Malik Fleming right there. And there's the first flag. when the guy starts changing direction and stuff, like, I know that's cool to watch. But I just go ahead and start thinking about offense the minute somebody changes direction on punt return, because if it is a touchdown, it's coming back.
That was a 36-yard punt right there, and there's going to be a penalty on South Fulton right here.
My guess is blocking the back. What'd he say? I missed the call.
That's what it was.
Blocking the back, blindside block. These are things that I anticipate on punt return.
So now South Fulton takes over, and once again, they're at their own – this is their best field position. They're at their own 17.
Well, they were putting together a pretty good drive before they shot themselves in the foot last time.
Mm-hmm.
Coming down to empty look with Tripp set to the field. Looks like they're all waiting on a play.
First time we've been in empty.
All right, here we go. There's a snap. Quarterback drops. Lots of pressure. Good Lord. The two defensive ends were like, hey, I'll meet you at the quarterback. All right. That number 90, was he part of that?
Yes.
That's number 90, Anthony Bonner out of Columbus. I'm trying to see what the other 90 and number 94, Kevon Peterson out of Hardaway, they kind of just decided to meet at the quarterback right there. I was told that Mr. Bonner is a 4.46 in the 40 coming off the edge right there.
Well, he kind of looked like it, didn't he?
I tell you what, he got back there in a hurry. I don't know if I'm more impressed by him or Kevon Peterson, because Kevon Peterson's kind of a big guy.
You're going to make me go back to my old school days. I coached a guy named Kevon Peterson, so that was the first name I thought of when you said that.
Well, I'm pretty sure this is Kevon.
Got delay of game right here.
Oh, that is just golly. It is pouring right now on the South Fulton offense.
Yes, it is.
Well, they can't catch a break.
You might want to be careful right here. You just gave up a sack. That was a 10-yard loss. Now you're throwing it from your own end zone, unless this is quarterback draw.
There's a snap. Quarterback drops, looks, lets it fly.
Oh, he caught it.
Oh, my goodness.
And it's a first down.
That was a great play. I really thought that was going the other way. That ball caught by number 13. Trayvon Freeman, I believe. Is that 13 or 12 right there? He's walking to us.
13, Coach.
Okay.
26-yard gain and a first down.
I thought that number 41, DeMarcus Hood,
was going to pick it.
Was going the other way with that.
Yes, me too.
Empty look again for South Fulton. This seems to be working for them. Trips to the field. Quick throw out to the right side. Just throw and catch. Nice pickup on first down.
Gain of about 6 on first down.
Yep. I think that was number 88 on the catch.
It was.
Number 88, that is – well, it can be 88, maybe 83. Gabe Reeves. Nope, he's not from Westlake. Sorry, buddy, I'm having a hard time with your numbers right there.
83.
It was 83?
Yes.
Empty look again. Quarterback in the gun. Lets it fly out to the right-hand side again. He's just taking what they'll give him. That's all he's doing.
Another first down.
Smart football.
Another 6-yard gain. So, after the big sack and the penalty, when everything looked like it was going to be bad, 26-yard gain, three straight completions, two first downs, and South Fulton's got something rolling right here. Staying in this empty look.
Yeah, it seems to be pretty good to them right now.
Seems like they've identified we're not going to run the football against this front.
There's a snap. And there it got.
And there it is.
See, I thought he should have kept running.
Yeah.
And it looked like the ball came out.
It did come out. And it was number 94 that caused all the havoc.
So far, Kevon Peterson having a pretty big day. Coach Baker, true to his word here, this D-line has been a force.
Gentlemen, how are you doing tonight?
Oh.
This evening, this afternoon, and this morning.
All three pretty good.
I snuck in behind you and turned up my volume a little bit. Wanted to tell everybody that during halftime, we will go away for roughly about 5 minutes to acquire some stats, take a breather, eat some food, and get back into action. And we'll come back in towards the end of half to talk a little bit about the first half analysis.
Quarterback draw right here.
Well, I got a face mask.
We got a gain of five, too.
It's amazing how intense these coaches take these two games.
I mean, it is,
you
man.
You got walkie-talkies up here. The second game, they're rolling in instant replay. They want to be able to review the play after the play. Muscogee won last year 17-14, or they run in overtime. So it's definitely wanting to see that pride of that county to say, hey, we're going to continue to win here.
And just be honest, a lot of these guys know each other. You don't want to lose to your friend.
No.
There's a snap. Quarterback drops.
Hello.
Oh. I'm pretty sure that's Kevon Peterson right there on the play. Golly, that guy's killing him. Who else was in there right there? Is that number 98?
Yes.
Number 98, Devontae Fanning. Devontae Fanning says feed him.
Mm-hmm.
I feel you, big fella.
Well, there's one thing about it. You can go empty. But if you're going to try to hold the football and throw it deep down the field with this front, you're going to be in trouble.
No, you should go empty and get on the move. Go empty and run the quarterback. But don't go empty and stand there.
No, because if you do, you're a
– sitting duck.
You're an immobile target.
Yeah, you know, it's like shooting fish in a barrel for the D-line right here.
And the quarterbacks at halftime are going to be requesting a 12th man to block.
Well, the thing is there's a good chance that number 90 is faster than any quarterback they'll put out there.
That's frightening. So it looks like we're going to get a punt right here.
With 51 seconds left in the half, Muscogee protecting a 7-point lead, getting ready to get the ball back. If I'm not mistaken, that's number 22, Corey Calhoun, back deep for Muscogee.
Is.
There's a low spinning kick. He's caught on the run, and he just kind of runs out of bounds. But he went forward.
That was a 30-yard punt.
Uh-oh.
And a 5-yard return. Here we go.
Come on, fellas. Come on now. You know, it's
– he got to 41 seconds for half before he had it, Coach.
I always hate when the kids act like this, and I understand football is an emotional game. I get it. I am an emotional cat, so I completely understand. I empathize. However, you got to be smart. You know, if this doesn't offset, it should be offsetting, but if it doesn't offset – you had decent field position. You got 41 seconds. You might could get points out of this.
Got two timeouts, too.
And
doesn't look like it's going to offset, Coach.
It should have. And the problem is now you've got a dynamic setup where now the teams are jawing at each other if they weren't already.
Yep.
And so now you basically took yourself – out of a potential scoring opportunity.
Yeah, it's not – this is a take a knee and go to half right here.
Because that 15 yards was a premium 15 yards.
Mm-hmm.
That's a shame. You know, and that's one of these lessons these kids have got to learn. And keep in mind, you want to use this film for, you know, recruiting for the guys that haven't signed yet.
So you got first and 10 at the 20 with 41 seconds left. How do you attack?
There's a snap. There's a man out of the backfield right there. He thought he had him, and he just throws it away wisely. That's Jalen Joyner, just gets rid of it. He had a back swing out to the right side real quick, and I thought he had something right there. But, you know.
South Fulton did a good job of plastering to those guys. The back was open early, but when he didn't throw it right off the rip, he did a good job of getting it out of his hands, not taking the sack, not giving him a chance to get a sack and a fumble right there.
But as soon as that back cleared the line, he had to get rid of that one mm-hmm. right then if he was going to throw it.
You got to realize that just about everything that you're doing right now, you're going to get a pass rush. If you're going to do anything right here, it might be the best down to throw the screen to the running back right here.
Rolled up coverage right there. Joyner looking, throws it across the middle.
Oh.
And if they don't run into each other, either one of them picks that. But dangerous throw right there.
Like the pass was broken up by number 18.
Number 18, that's going to be Eric McNary.
And now.
Tri-Cities, yeah, thanks.
And now this is what you didn't want to have happen. There's still 29 seconds left, and you're at third down. So if you don't get anything right here, you're going to have to punt, and you're going to give South Fulton a chance to steal points right before the half.
That's the last thing you want to do is give up a short field right here before halftime.
And you're going to get a delay of game.
Yep, there it is. Big Mo has turned. Where everything looked like Muscogee.
All because of what? Penalty.
Yep. Better known as a drive killer.
Yesterday it was turnovers. Today it's been penalties.
Trip set to the field on the right side. Single receiver to the left. Joyner waiting on the snap. Looked like everybody kind of an early start right there. Joyner decides to call his own number. And nice open field tackle right there.
That number 38.
Coach. I can't see that. The green numbers on the black jersey, I got no chance. But, yeah, I do think you're right. I do think that was number 33, Torian Spencer.
He's from Langston Hughes?
He is.
Yes.
Looks like they took their final timeout.
Well –
actually, who called that one?
South Fulton probably called the timeout so they can get the punt right here and give themselves a chance for a return. Look for shenanigans, reverse on the punt return, things like that.
Yeah, that'd be a good time for it.
The first punt from Muscogee was 36 yards, but the snap was –
horrendous.
You said it, I didn't. I was going to say left a lot to be desired.
I mean, Xavier Clark was back there dribbling the ball, trying to pick it up, chased it around. If there had been any rush at all, you know.
Well, they actually had a guy come through, and the referee was yelling at him, don't block it, don't block it, don't block it.
Yeah. Malik Fleming deep for South Fulton. Mr. Clark goes up the field that one. And he wisely angles it.
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds. Very wise. Nicely done.
32-yard punt. No return right there.
That is the key. And you've got 8 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
You basically have time for one long play.
So you're going to get the Big Ben right if you can get it off right here. The only thing that really did was it helped the field position for this half for the South Fulton team.
I might go with a screen here. Something on the interior.
See if you can get it out and get somebody blocking and then split a seam and outrun them to the end
maybe
zone.
Maybe get lucky. I mean, that's what you're hoping for right here.
Shallow cross and from the two receiver side and let these three guys throw a block and let's go.
Something. You got to have something. I mean, you're going to have to pop something right here. It's not going to be, you know, throw and catch. You don't have time for that. There's snap, quarterback drops, lots of heat right there, and they are –
there he is. Oh, my Lord, he's wide open in the end zone.
And quarterback gets run out of bounds. That's Caleb Dixon on the carry.
Gain of 11 to end the first half.
Well, at the end of the first half, 7-0 Muscogee. Well, that's a pretty good ball game right here, Coach.
It's not bad. I enjoyed it. You know, I see they trying to get the 1 second rule from Alabama and Auburn put back in right here.
I'm not sure what they're talking about.
Saying he ran out of bounds before the end of the half.
Okay.
Well, there it is.
I mean, outside of Colquitt County, I've never seen anybody put time back on the clock like that at the request of a coach.
Yikes.
I'll tell you what, I've been part of a number of games where there's obvious clock errors and nobody fixes them.
Yes.
So. Well, so far, a really good start here to the Minority Coaches Association Senior Bowl Classic. This first game, South Fulton versus Muscogee County has been pretty evenly matched, I thought. I know after halftime we'll talk about some stats. But until then, folks, we'll be back soon.
Right now, Florida was beating Michigan 13-0. Thank you.
All right, welcome back here to Lakewood Stadium in beautiful Atlanta, Georgia, for the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic. There we go. Took me a second. That's a mouthful, buddy. All right, but got back and, you know, getting ready to break from halftime. Thought I'd give you some stats, Coach Chapman.
Yeah, for Muscogee County, they had 9 rushes for 15 yards in the first half. Passing stats, they had 6 completions on 12 attempts for 84 yards. They threw 1 touchdown and 1 interception. Their average starting field position was the 33-yard line. They had 3 penalties for 35 yards, and they had a whopping 5 tackles for a loss for 29 yards, 4 of those being sacks, 3 of them courtesy of number 94, Kevon Peterson from Hardaway. For South Fulton, they rushed it 15 times for 28 yards. They were also 6 of 12 passing for 80 yards. They had their average starting field position was their own 18, so you can see kind of the way the game went for them. They spent their whole time backed up into their own end of the field. They had 4 penalties for 25 yards, and they had 2 tackles for a loss, netting 4 yards. Coach Collins, you got some things that you would like to show on the instant replay from the first half highlights?
Well, in my opinion, you know, we talked about this. One of the biggest plays of the game so far, right here early on, Joyner takes a snap, drops, and gets the ball back out to number 15. That's Jarius Thomas right there on that screen play. If you remember, that was a big third down for them.
Mm-hmm.
And then shortly after that, they come out and they go with that trips look again. And Joyner takes a snap, lets it fly, and it's actually picked by Malik Fleming. Fleming, you see, turns out of the end zone, has a great return, but it's one of those deals where somebody blocked behind the ball. Let me bring that back just a little bit. Here it is. The guy's behind him. Well, crap almighty. There it is. I knew I saw it. There it is. Just clips him right in the back. If you can see right there, my best John Madden, right there, he just nails him in the back. And I don't think the guy would have caught him. But what happens is then you get this big return by Fleming, who cuts back and makes all these amazing moves and proves, you know, why he's going to East Carolina. Gets down there and – instead, on the ensuing play, instead of it being first and 10 from their own – from the 40 going in, now it's first and 10 from the 4-yard line. And that's when Muscogee comes down and scores on, what, 3 plays later?
Yes.
Well, having said all that, we're getting ready to line up for the kickoff right here. And there's South Fulton on the kick. And that's a booming kick. That was a great kick right there.
We were told that guy was hurt.
Yeah, that's in the end zone right there. Yeah, because that's the guy from Hapeville. Is that correct?
No, Creekside. He's from Creekside.
He's the healthiest kicker.
That's what they said.
They said he's not healthy, but he's the healthiest one. I think maybe that guy's got a soccer background.
Well, he hammered that thing. It was high and deep into the end zone.
I was about to say, because he thumped that one.
All right, so looks like they're going to bring the sniffer back in, so might be a little bit of power football right here to start off the second half.
Well, they had a little luck with that. And, you know, again, if you just stay true to it, you know, that sniffer back is going to give you some options in your counter game.
Which we haven't seen yet.
And both coaches talked about it. But as for now, you got slot to the left, sniffer to the left. So I'm guessing left. There's a snap, little zone right in the middle, and it all opened up big and then closed in a hurry.
Gain of 1 on first down is going to bring up 2nd and 9 right here for Muscogee County.
You know, so far for me, the outside of that one big play where they throw the interception, which actually you know, the penalty on the interception ends up being the difference in the game, in my opinion. Muscogee still had to put together several plays to score when it ended up with Joyner to Thomas in the back of the corner of the end zone. Mm-hmm. There's a snap, quick give off the right side, and they're really trying to stick to the run right now. It's a little early to be grinding the clock.
Well, that was two more, so it's going to bring up third and seven right here. In the first half, Muscogee County converted 40% of their third down, so it should be interesting to see. They're going to go back to their spread set right here.
That's Donovan Carter at quarterback right there. Waiting on the snap. There it is. He drops. Comes around the right side, and he's decided he's going to run. Nice open field tackle right there by Sal Fulton.
And so we're going to get to see our first punt of the third quarter, Coach Collins.
Yes, sir. But as I was saying before, to me, that Muscogee D-line has been the story outside of that one big play, just dominating up front.
There's no other way about it. You know, when you've got minus 29 yards on just, you know, five negative plays, and they haven't, you know, when you run it 15 times and get 28 yards, so you're averaging less than two a carry, it shows the dominance of those four guys because you're not really blitzing. You know, you can run a game or two up front, but you're not really doing anything.
Yeah, they, you know, Kevon Peterson had a – is that a delay?
Yes, it is a delay.
Kevon Peterson had a sack off a twist stunt, but it was actually one of those deals where the quarterback had evaded the rush, but he just didn't give up on it and ended up getting sacked because the quarterback stopped. And you and I talk all the time about once you start running as a quarterback, when you stop, everybody else is still running.
They certainly are.
And that's going to hurt really bad.
South Fulton's got a chance to get really good field position to start – third quarter.
Malik Fleming, who we both know is very dangerous, standing at the 50. Clark catches the ball, catches the snap right there, and Fleming lets it bounce off his foot. It's mishandled. There's a dog
pile right
there.
South Fulton got it back.
Man, he got lucky because that one came right off his foot.
33-yard punt right there. South Fulton will take over at their own 47-yard line.
Now, gentlemen, I'm going to chime in real quick to talk a little bit about Muscogee County. The head coach is coming from Hardaway County on that part. Nope, other one. There we go. And have y'all talked about the counties, all the schools inside the county yet?
We discussed where everybody was from, yes.
Okay, I'm going to chime in a little bit and talk about playoffs. Go ahead.
All right. Doubles look for South Fulton. Quick give up the middle. Man, nice, tough run. My goodness, give that cat the ball.
Well, I had an opportunity with eight teams in the county. Four made the playoffs this year, which is really amazing. From a winning percentage-wise, this county is really at 41% winning percentage. They had 35 wins, 50 losses, had 85 games overall-wise. Hardaway, Spencer, Carver, Columbus, and Columbus, both all four teams made the playoffs.
Doubles look again. Motion coming from left to right. End up giving on the zone, and there he goes. They took my advice. They gave that cat the ball again. I'm trying to catch a number right here, but his jersey's all scrunched up. Where's he from, Banneker? Is that the silver helmet?
Yes, that is.
Yeah, it's the silver. And the next time South Fulton gets the ball, I'll talk a little bit about South Fulton and their success this past year from an overall area perspective. And I'll leave you all to your game so you don't leave me alone.
I'm still trying to see what that kid's number is. He's running that thing. 14. Thank you very much. There's a snap. Uh-oh. Yeah. Somebody zigged where they should have zagged on that one. Yeah, you can't have a mistake in the backfield against this defensive line.
No, sir.
That was Jashari Anderson who carried on those early two carries. I think Mr. Anderson at the quarterback won. Somebody went the wrong way on that one.
And that wrong way cost him 3 yards and puts him at second and 13. And right now, Coach, this is just about their, deepest penetration into Muscogee County territory.
That's Caleb Dixon at quarterback right there for South Fulton. But that D-line, man, is just the pressure.
Yes.
And they are some big cats too, buddy.
Got another delay.
My goodness, the penalties today. And now you go from bad to worse.
Mm-hmm.
You have a negative play, which looked like a miscommunication. And then you have, in my opinion, what is an organizational penalty.
Yep. Second and 18 now. You don't want to be holding the ball with this.
There's a snap. Quarterback draw. He just lets it go out to the right side.
Oh, man.
I thought he was going to catch that.
I thought he got both hands on it.
I tell you what, if Caleb Dixon gives a little air up underneath that ball, I think he might still be running.
Pass broken up by number 7 right there. Ian Rome from Columbus. I like his name, considering that's my name.
Ian Rome from Columbus?
Yes. Think he gets confused?
Maybe. And it's third and long.
Here comes
Kevon Peterson.
I was wondering if anybody else saw that.
Tell you what.
The quarterback knows he's in the game.
Yep, get the ball out of your hand, kid.
Right now.
There's a snap. Hard push. There's a little screen action. And he was out in the open and had a real shot at making a big play right there. Kid from Westlake, I'm trying to see a number. I still can't see that. 20, thank you. Number 20, Christian Davis from Westlake High School. One of my favorite players from Westlake.
Yeah.
Mr. Cam Newton.
Yes, he's an Auburn fan.
That's right. Air good years and bad years.
It was a good first half yesterday. I know that much.
It's about time. We've been storing those points up all season.
Well, best way to use them is when everybody's watching.
There's a snap and what looks to be a rather short kick. It takes a good roll.
About a 27-yard punt right there.
And it's going to be first and 10 for Muscogee from their own 20.
Where'd they mark this ball at?
Pretty sure it's on the 20-yard line. Let's see. There's lots of people wandering around like they're not sure where they're going.
Yeah. I mean.
Yeah. I'm waiting to hear the yeah.
So it is first and 10 from the 20. Got a little tight set right here. This could be some trickeration, Coach.
What we refer to as the nasty set. There's a snap.
Smash.
Joiner drops. Gets it out to the left side.
Hello. They're going to call a penalty on that. That was a heck of a tackle.
I mean, yeah, you got tackled and you got slammed down. I mean, I guess you can make an argument for unnecessary roughness right there, but I don't think that's that big a deal. Like, if you don't like being slammed down, don't let yourself be picked up. I'm just saying. Like, I don't have that problem a whole lot.
No. Why is that, Coach?
You're going to be a big son of a gun, you pick me up like that. Although I will say, I have been, as a child at 285 pounds when I played, I have been picked up just like that and thrown over somebody's head. So
you're going to get a 6-yard gain on the pass and then add 15 more on the penalty. It'll bring up first and 10.
But my thing is, how's that not offsetting? He lost his mind after he got slammed.
Yes, he did.
I mean, I understand you got slammed on the ground. I get it, but you know, bad stuff happens when you play this game.
You know, if we had this thing, if this was a clinic speak, we could do it for our guys to show them what we always talk about. Do not stop and run back to the middle. Bigger people are coming from inside. Just run
away from the people. That seems like a no-brainer, but, you know, here we are. All right, Muscogee on the move, though, after that big penalty and good play right there. Here's a snap. Quick give of the middle.
Nice run.
Ball like popped out there at the very end.
They're gonna call him down.
Yep, looks like it. That was number 11 on the carry right there for Muscogee.
Picked up nice gain of 4 yards right there on first down. Bring up 2nd and 6 right here for Muscogee County, and they can, you know, you made the joke about it's too early to bleed the clock, but we're getting close to 5 minutes right here in the third quarter, Coach. And if they can hold on to the football for a little while and put some points on the board, it makes it really hard on the team from South Fulton.
Yeah, it does. All right, there's a snap, man. Still, everybody's starting early. Everybody's starting early.
It looks like it, doesn't it?
Well, is that somebody's sleeve or is that a flag? Okay, somebody's towel.
All right. Same color as the flag.
Yeah.
So it's going to bring up 3rd down again?
So it seems.
So now sitting there at converting 2 of 6, this is a big 3rd down because, like you said, if you convert this, you can take another 2 minutes off the clock right here and flip the field, which you've basically flipped the field right now. But it makes it a whole lot harder when someone has to go 80 or 90 than when they have to go 50.
Trips, there's a snap.
That guy was offside.
He's got a run, buddy.
Wide open.
Wide open down the middle of the field. So.
That was 25 yards on the completion right there for a 1st down.
That's a huge play right there for Muscogee.
Yeah, you know, you take a 3rd and 6. You gain 25 on that. Move it right on down the field.
There's a snap. Quick give up the middle right there.
Yeah, that cat right there from Langston Hughes is playing.
Yeah, that was Trey Lee. Stopped by
number
32. Number 32, Calvin White. Quarterback in the gun, doubles. Joiner waiting on a snap. There it is. Quick give to Lee. Lee starts
nice
right
move.
But comes back left. Man.
Yes, sir.
Great job staying up. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Late hit. A penalty yet again.
So after a 1 yard gain, it looks like you're going to get 15 more.
I tell you what, man. Right now, penalties have been the name of the game.
Yes, and they've really killed South Fulton.
You know, we did a game yesterday, and the big thing was turnovers. In particular, red zone turnovers.
Yes.
But today, you know, they've done a pretty good job. The times that the ball has come out, that there's been a fumble, it's kind of bounced back. But, okay, here we go. Trips into the boundary. Quarterback run up top.
Zone down here.
Quarterback
shallow.
Drops, looks, lets it fly. I don't understand that one.
I can't believe they're going to call pass interference on this.
That
was a really nice play.
Again, penalties. What are we at? 45 yards in penalties right here? On this drive alone?
Well, this one will be half the distance because of it's inside the 30. But, yeah, if we were just going off of straight penalty numbers. So they're going to call that a half the distance. So they're at the 17 should go to about the 8.5. So that actually comes out to about a 9-yard penalty right there, Coach. So right now,
39-yard
penalty.
39 yards in penalties on this drive for South Fulton.
And now you go back to your sniffer back. It's 1st and goal. And this is the first trip for anybody inside the red zone.
And here we go. Sniffer back off to the right, slot to the left, quarterback in the gun, give on the zone, quick penetration by South Fulton right there. Just nowhere to go for Trey Lee. So, you know, this would be a great place for South Fulton to kind of bow their backs right here.
I'm looking right now for Muscogee to throw the wide receiver screen.
Well, I'm thinking they're either going to Cameron Vinicius. I'm guessing that's how you say it, Vinicius.
Yeah,
we're gonna go with Vinicius, like Hennessy.
Yeah. Well, he was the one that caught the touchdown pass in the first half.
He was.
Mm-hmm.
There's a quarterback on the run. Joyner's on the move, and he's gonna get out of bounds at about the 5 yard line, and that's gonna be enough for a first down.
Nope. Well, is it?
Indeed, sir, it is. So now it's Muscogee first and goal from about the 5.
It is a first down. There we go.
And the way they've been running the ball, if they've got 4 downs to do it, I think they get in.
Be interesting to see what they attack with right here. Every time they put the sniffer back in, they've gotten smashed for 2 yards. They've been much more effective running out of this.
There's trips into the boundary. Back offset to the left side.
Quarterback.
Joyner just takes off.
Hello.
Oh. Golly. He spun and got a mouthful of linebacker right there.
You might not want to do that when you're inside the pocket.
My goodness.
It's going to bring up second goal from the 4.
Yeah, you better be careful spinning like that. We get a number on that guy? He was from Banneker.
Yes, he was.
I could see that. Maybe Draquan Eason. Lots of pressure right there on Joyner. He's able to roll.
Dropped.
Completes it, and then the ball's dropped. Good job extending the play there by Joyner. Good pressure by South Fulton. Third and 3. I tell you what, man, might should have just run the ball.
I know one thing, if they're not supposed to be blitzing, somebody's getting heated up in there.
Well.
Either that or this defensive end on our side is getting the greatest jump off the ball in the history of the world.
That's a possibility. That was a tough spot to play, that offensive tackle. There's motion from right to left. There he
touchdown.
Is all by himself. He's in there again. That's his second one of the day.
Yes, sir.
Cameron Vinicius. And just like that, you know, the coaches right there doing their best to get things under control right there. A couple guys kind of heated up.
Yeah, this game got a chance to get interesting in the fourth quarter. If they if it gets out of hand.
All right. They're going to line up to kick. They won't receive any pressure right here. See what kind of snap we get. And it's a fieldable snap. And Xavier Clark punches it through. All right. Right here, just a recap of what's going on, how Muscogee got in, brought that motion. Cross that started in doubles, brought motion from right to left, and then we see it looks like a pick, but they don't really have to do anything because everybody runs down inside, and there's Vinicius all by his lonesome.
Nice play call.
Touchdown.
Nice play call. Run double slants, put the motion guy on the basic, you know, short wheel route.
I mean, that is a staple even out of a trips look, to bring those double slants from the outside and wheel the inside man out.
It is, and it's been run for 100 years. So, I mean, you know, since they invented the forward pass, somebody's been running inside to pick somebody.
But the tail of that drive, though, 39 yards in penalties.
Yes, it is exactly right.
How long was the entire drive, Coach Chapman?
Well, the drive started – at the 20-yard line. So it was an 80-yard drive, so you have 39
and
yards.
Half of its penalties.
There it is.
Golly, that's a – and now you're down by 2 scores.
So
it's a 2-possession game now. That's
– you got
2:21 left in the third quarter. You got plenty of time if you're South Fulton. But right now, the fairly dominant performance by Muscogee.
I've been in this situation before in All-Star games where you're down and you have the chance to come back. A lot of times kids will take it upon themselves to do something spectacular.
Xavier Clark has a decent kick.
Still not down.
That kid runs tough. That is.
So they're going to start at the 31-yard line right here.
That was number 14, if I'm not mistaken, on the return. Is that him, Jashari Anderson?
Mm-hmm.
That guy runs the ball tough.
Be interesting to see what they go with right here. You know, they had a pretty decent drive. Started off, you know, with two really good running plays. Then they had the, you know, the miscommunication in the backfield, you know, on the first down play.
I think you come back to the empty look and start playing your two-man game.
I don't think there's enough people on the field for Muscogee County right here.
And there's the give.
And they ran right where there wasn't anybody at.
Around the right side. That was pretty well done.
Gain of nine.
That was number 14, Jashari Anderson again.
And they didn't have enough people on the field.
Yeah, oops. And there he is.
Yeah, he wasn't on the field, Coach.
Kevon Peterson. I tell you what, man, when we play somebody that's got a really good D-line, I know who's in and who's out every play. Here comes somebody. Quarterback drops. He looks. He lets it fly down the right sideline. Well covered by Muscogee.
That's a smart play call. It's second and one. Take your shot right there.
Yeah, why not, man? You know you can get a yard.
You hope you can get a yard.
Well,
now I know nobody would think about this call on this point in time in the game, but their best running play so far has been the zone read, and you know it'd be a really the best running play. They had an 18-yard gain off the quarterback keeper on the zone read.
There's a snap.
And there's the zone read,
and does a great job. Jashari Anderson makes the first man miss because the D line is there at the mesh point.
Yes, gain five. Picked up another first down. That's their eighth first down of the day.
I'm not sure how big that cat is, but he's one of those cats that a wise old coach told me one time you wouldn't be able to touch in a phone booth.
He's in the bed. He turns the light switch off and is in the bed before the room gets dark.
Yeah, that's a quick joker. All right, here we go. Doubles look. Quarterback in the gun. There's a snap, and there goes the quarterback.
Quarterback
stumble.
Sweep.
And wow. Just a running. I like that play.
Gain of 12 right there. Well, there's something. You know, South Fulton has found something here in the second half. Their run game was really bottled up in the first half, and now all of a sudden it's come to life. You know, they've completed one pass here in the second half for minus 1 yard. Everything they've done has been on the ground.
I might go to Slocum again now. Timeout, South Fulton. They have too many guys out there?
I don't think so.
First and 10. Afraid of a delay, I guess.
Yeah. Because remember the last drive, they had the 3-yard loss. Then the delay put them at second 18, and it kind of ruined that drive. So you're down here at the 41. You know, this is one of those things. It's right at the end of the quarter. You know, if you've got something that you have saved, a trick of some sort, now might be the time to do it. Funky formation, you know, reverse pass. You know, you got to do something to jumpstart your team, get a little momentum going. You know, that's a double-edged sword, too, because once you do something crazy like that, if it doesn't work, you know, then you've wasted it.
See, this is just my thought. I come out in doubles. I put Slocum and Anderson in the backfield together, fake the zone, and run the slam.
Counter with the quarterback?
Counter with the quarterback. Quarterback slam.
Whoever those pulling guards, that guard and that tackle that are pulling, are going to have to be ready because these cats coming off the edge right here are coming with a reckless abandon.
You're right about that.
I'm just telling you.
And there's motion.
Jet. They got the corner.
They got the edge. Oh, uh-oh. He breaks a couple tackles. There he goes. And he gets pulled down right there. Looks like number 18 for Muscogee was able to make the tackle.
That was a 30-yard gain right there, Coach.
Tyree Howard saved a touchdown right there, Coach Chapman. That was a huge play.
It was nice, too. I mean, they got everything they wanted. They got the seal. They got the down block on the linebacker. And then one nice cut set it up really nicely for them. So now they're sitting there looking at their first red zone trip. And we're going to do that in the fourth quarter, Coach.
That was a really good job right there, you know, knowing when to stop stretching and start cutting. All right. Take a couple glances here at what happened in the third quarter. Right here, this is where it starts right here. You see right here, a little extracurricular. Yeah, he caught some air right there. and he gets smashed right here on the ground. But that's going to be the first penalty in that drive. And what would end up being a total of 39 yards in penalties on an 80-yard drive. And then, of course, what capped the drive, which I'm sure everybody's seen, just a doubles look for Muscogee. Vennessy comes across, and if you'll watch, the receivers are going to come down inside. He's going to continue on his path, and he's just going to loop out here, and he's going to be standing all by himself. There he is. The DB's got screened off, you know, and you can make an argument that that's a pick play, an illegal pick, and as an offensive guy, we call that a rub. But here we go. South Fulton on the move. Motion from left to right. To a slot look.
Hitch.
Quick throw out to the left side. Play made right there by number 7, Ian Rome.
See how they rotated the secondary right there, Coach? Looked like they were staying in a cover 3 down here or a cover 1. But, you know, you had an opening right there for the hitch.
Well, it was there if the ball's thrown
catchable.
If the ball's thrown, you know, you can't throw the ball high. You're not going to make any friends at quarterback doing that.
Why not?
That pass was intended for number 11, Devin Hall.
Same formation they ran the jet out of right here, Coach.
Here comes the motion from left to right.
Quarterback lead.
Slocum. And Anderson did a pretty good job blocking right there, too.
Yes, sir.
He's a scrappy joker, I'll tell you that.
Gain of 5. It's going to bring up 3rd and 5 right here.
So, 3rd and 5. And here comes Peterson.
Might not be a bad play to look at that screen they threw last time when there was nobody there.
I tell you what. I would be careful throwing – you know, I said before I would throw an interior screen. The more I watch these guys play, these guys don't look like they – with the exception of number 93, don't look like they play on the offensive line.
No, they do not.
Those might be skill guys up front, in which case it might be a bad idea. And there's a delay of game, man. That is a backbreaker.
Mm-hmm.
3rd and 5 turns into 3rd and 10.
And the story continues to be penalties.
Penalties have been the bane of South Fulton's existence today. Doubles look for South Fulton. Motion from left to right. Slocum getting pressure. Gets
nice
away.
Job getting away.
Great job. And they shove him out of bounds. He's going to be.
He should be down close to the 9 right there.
So 4th and 4?
No, Coach. 4th and about 1.5.
1 3/4. 1 11/16.
So he gained right at 8 on that. So we're going to say it's 4th and 2.
All right. Nice job by Mr. Slocum.
See if they get quarterback lead right here.
I mean, that's what I would do. There's a snap. And that's exactly what you get. And –
I think they knew
like
it was too.
Everybody on Muscogee's team like knew what the play was going to be. and that's hurtful.
Yep.
Like, that hurts your feelings as an offensive line coach.
But that's that, you know, that front right there. You're running into the belly of the beast.
The teeth of the monster, indeed.
Yeah. So now that's going to give Muscogee County a chance to milk some clock from their starting at their own 10 right here.
Well, yeah, now's a good time to milk the clock. You got 10:52 left in the game. You're up by two touchdowns.
I wouldn't do it with the sniffer back, though. I'm sorry. Every time he's been in the game, I've gotten smashed.
Yeah, but
now they got the tight. He's in it tight end now.
You're so at the beginning of the fourth quarter. Look at the hole right there.
Mm-hmm.
You guys go to the tight end side. Look at the size of the bubble.
Mm-hmm.
And what we're talking about is that gap between the defensive end and the defensive tackle on the offensive right. It's just huge. And it just begs to be run into. We appreciate everybody tuning in for the beginning of the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic. This first game between South Fulton and Muscogee. Don't forget to stay tuned for APS versus Clayton. There's a snap. Joyner gets the ball
right
quick to the left side. Big time play right there by number 8. That's Jameel Williams from Hapeville Charter. What does that helmet look like? I can't see those numbers. Heads up play right there. Big time open field play. Thank you, number 6. If it wasn't for the people that support us. Number 6, Gary Benton. But nice open field play.
What school is Gary from?
Gary Benton is from Banneker. I thought it was a Westlake helmet.
That's what it looked like to me. Maybe they changed.
Yeah. You know, it's not beyond the kids to swap jerseys and whatnot. Quarterback lets it fly, and he trips. That was Venice right there.
No, I don't have a problem with that right there. You're up 2 scores. The last thing you want to do is throw an interception down tight. If you throw that ball and it's picked off, it's basically a punt.
If you're gonna miss long.
Yes, and to the outside. So now it's going to bring up a punt with 9 minutes left to go. And, you know, if I'm South Fulton, I'm banking on this punt being the turn in the game. I need a huge return right here.
If I'm Muscogee, I'm angling this one out of bounds.
I am too.
And you see what they just did? They moved. They put Anderson back, moved Fleming over to try and head off anything that might be going out of bounds.
Somebody's fixing to pick this up. Yep. I knew it was going to happen.
Yep. In true Honey Badger fashion, that ball scooped up by number 10. And just like that, there's a flag.
Got another flag?
Yes.
Are you kidding me? And another
there's
flag.
There's another one.
The yellow rain has found us here.
And they're letting kind of both teams kind of migrate onto the field.
And this is going to turn bad.
Somebody better get control of this quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Like?
Good job by the coaching staffs getting out there and kind of wrangling the troops to make sure that everybody is kind of staying under wraps. That ball returned by number 10, Lazarus Anderson. It's a great name.
It is. I had a joke, but I will refrain from it.
Well, I appreciate that. I'm sure that they do as well.
And we are going to get the offsetting penalties, Coach. So nobody is going to
see, and that's fortunate for South Fulton and dumb on Muscogee's part.
It is,
you know.
Now South Fulton's got a short field. You know, if you look at it.
You got 9 minutes. That's a lot of time.
It's the same recipe for scoring that Muscogee used in the first half when they had the interception and the penalty that backed them up. And they punted from their own end zone. They got a very short punt, had a short field and scored. You know, you just had a really nice drive from South Fulton. And, you know, they went, you know, 60 yards and didn't get anything out of it. But now they're short, you know, it's shortened up. If they bust one thing, you know, they're right there sitting on the doorstep. And then, you know, if you can score a touchdown right here and get the conversion, it makes things a little bit more interesting.
Looks like Dixon back at quarterback.
And,
uh-oh.
What we got? Timeout, so, yeah. Muscogee County.
No, it looked like South Fulton timeout.
Well, he's pointing the wrong direction then. Well, either way, there's a timeout on the field.
Yeah, no matter what on that part. And get a chance to talk a little bit about South Fulton, mainly because they're in the lead 14-0 right now. Am I correct in understanding that?
Yes, sir.
All right, make sure my brain's on the same
now,
page.
Now, hold on. What was your last statement?
What are you talking about, man? That South Fulton was winning 14-0.
No, they're down 14-0.
They're down 14-0.
And I wasn't listening to you.
Yeah, you just agreed to anything that I said right there. That's
sure, why not?
Yeah, all right.
Hey, you're my boss.
No, South Fulton definitely did not call the timeout. I thought, you know, it's my brain working in different directions. But one thing about South Fulton, as you talked about at the very beginning, that the size and where they're at, you would have thought, I mean, four of their teams had number one seeds this year.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Oh yeah, I mean, when you look at Hapeville Hornets, 10-2.
Ooh, nice run.
Golly, that kid.
Oh, another frustration. I'm going to talk through this frustration with Westlake Lions, 9-3. Langston Panthers went 4-6. Creekside's number one in their region at 8-4. Banneker went 9-2, won their region, and then we had Tri Cities. But out of that situation, I mean, it's 41 wins over 26 losses, 61%. Winning out of this South Fulton team. All three teams advanced to the second round. The only team that got ousted in the first round was Banneker. But all Creekside, Westlake, and Hapeville all lost in the second round. And they went the deepest. No, in this whole All-Star, nobody's went any deeper than the second round. But out of this group, you would think, you know, hey, this is a senior classic, so it makes me think maybe that there's a lot of juniors out there in the South Fulton world that's going to push this team to a little bit more. So wanted to have a chance to say that. Winston Gordon, Coach Gordon's the head coach for the Hapeville Hornets. He's the one coaching the team. If I'm incorrect, make sure that you correct me, Coach Chapman, to do that on that part. When the game's over with, we will have a little recap analysis, players of the game announced, and then we will shut down and get ready for the next game against APS in Clayton County. I'll take it back to you, gentlemen. Thank you.
You betcha, man.
All right, so you had the 15-yard penalty against South Fulton, so now you're looking at second down and, you know, what, 19? There's your counter.
There we go.
Oh.
He slipped. He's mad right now because he was fixing to bust it in and then cut back outside, and he had a chance.
Yes. Yes, he was.
I tell you what, Jashari Anderson has just put on a clinic today at running back.
But that's going to bring up 3rd and 10, Coach.
That's what happens when you end up in 3rd and 25.
Yep. I mean, it's one of those things. It's unfortunate that it happened, but, you know.
Trips look for South Fulton. There's a snap. Quarterback drops. Lets it fly down the sideline. Trying to go over the top, but number 7, Ian Rome in really good position right there.
A very nice play right there. He was right in. He was in phase with the guy, you know.
That whole put your shoulder in his chest.
And yes, sir.
Run to the sideline.
So now you with 8:15, you got to go for this. All right.
Yeah,
My thought process remains the same. If you've got something you've saved, you might want to bring it out right now.
And for crying out loud, keep extra people in the block.
There's too many people on the field again.
Yep, that's 12.
Nice job for the white hat not calling that.
That was nice of them.
Delay game.
Well, he didn't have to call it, and there was going to be a delay game anyway. How many delays a game is that?
Well, that's at least 5. That's 11 penalties, Coach. So
that's tough, man.
And there's 4th down. You know, I guess you could look at it, you know, if it's 4th and 10, then, you know, if you're going to run something on 4th and 10, you're going to run the same thing on 4th and 15 probably.
There's a snap. Dixon rolling to his right. Has a man, lets it fly, but he's short of the sticks.
He's going to come up 2 yards short. 13-yard completion. So that penalty, think about it. 5 yards just cost you the delay game just cost you the first down.
Yep.
And now with 8:07 left, Muscogee County takes over at their own 35-yard line.
It starts to get bleak.
Yes. And now we're going to see if this thing can stay on the rails or not, because the frustration has already shown through numerous times.
Yeah, that's always one of the things. You hope that cooler heads prevail, but, you know, they are kids. And kids don't always make the best decisions.
Heck, adults don't always make the best decisions, go.
You spot on right there, buddy. I've done several things I'm not proud of. I know that. Quick give around the right side, and a stingy South Fulton defense says, no, sir.
Loss of 5. Wow.
It looked like number 44 right there came through. DeAndre Moss.
Moss was one of those players they told us to look for.
DeAndre Moss out of Langston Hughes.
Before the game.
But Trey Lee was not going anywhere. But at this point, you know, if you're Muscogee County, you're just thinking run, clock, run.
Mm-hmm.
Doubles look for Muscogee. Quarterback rolls to the right and about gets his head ripped off.
Gained a yard right there.
Donovan Carter on the carry. Brought down by number 10, Lazarus Anderson.
It's going to bring up third down.
Third down and 15. So, you know, that's the thing. You had a chance to come out and just grind the clock, but you get behind the sticks. And, man, it's hard to be conservative and play from behind the sticks.
If you pick this up, though, but the next time they touch the ball, it's going to be under 5 minutes.
You better hurry and line up. Carter waits on the snap. And there it is.
Go. Coach Collins calls it.
I tell you what, man. If this had happened to me, what I would do is my team, part of our swag would be a wristband.
Mm-hmm.
Part of our swag that you got to keep would be a wristband, because it is easy to call from the line of scrimmage with a wristband. I should say easy. Easier.
Now they're changing personnel. They're fixing to get another delay of game.
Yep, here comes Mr. Vennessy. And
here comes the go route down here to him on the short
looks
side.
Looks like Fred Davis in at running back. There's a snap. Carter drops.
Oh, no.
And there he goes down the sideline. That is exactly what the doctor ordered. It's a touchdown right there. That's number 32. Calvin White from Hapeville, and so what looked very bleak took a quick turn. Just like that, it's a 7-point game with 6:25 left in the fourth quarter.
32-yard interception return for a touchdown right there.
Man, that was nice. South Fulton lining up.
Are they going for two right here, Coach?
I don't see why you would. Yeah. We're getting mixed signals from our support group here.
We don't have enough people on the field to do this.
Oh, dear. You can't take a penalty if you're not good at kicking.
Well, that kid just kicked the ball 5 yards deep in the end zone. I'm sure he can make it. Just take the –
There you go.
Attaboy.
Football.
This ain't our football routine to get them to stop the play clock. All right.
And here we go.
Mark it ready, White Hat. Here we go.
All right. Untimed down signal. Everybody appears to be ready. There's a snap. A hold. It's up and through.
It's good.
It's good.
This is interesting now.
All right. Here we go. Let's get into it a little bit. All right. They're changing personnel out, which we thought, okay, we thought they were going to Mr. Vennessey down the sideline. But right here, if you notice, this gentleman right here, he kind of has an idea of what's fixing to happen.
He is not fooled.
And it looked like the receiver was confused about what he had.
Either that or the quarterback threw a stop and he ran the wheel.
And then there he goes down the sideline and just gets in. And that was exactly what South Fulton needed right there. They needed something to go their way. And I tell you what, the last time we were here, I said something. I said this game is over. And then we were looking at overtime.
Well, don't say that today, all right?
Somebody, who was it? It was down 23-7 and just came storming back.
Hammered.
Speaking of storming, that kick just got – oh, no. Wow. That was – you couldn't have planned that better.
Oh,
and
man.
Just like that, okay, it's all coming up. It's all coming up South Fulton right here. I tell you what, the kicker thumped that one, but it hit right on the, like, half-yard line and then bounced back out of the end zone,
wow.
Forcing a return out of Muscogee. And now Muscogee is on their own 8-yard line. I tell you what, if the defense can come up with a couple of plays right here, South Fulton is going to get on the board, and we're going to have us a barn burner here.
Yep. It has turned around in one – just, you know, it's an amazing thing how it happened, but it turned around real, real fast.
I'm here to tell you, I guard number 10, Mr. Vennessey. I'm not going to let him catch the ball. There's a snap, Joyner rolls, and Mr. Vennessey was open for just a second, but good pressure up front.
I thought he was
by the South Fulton D line.
I thought he was about to make the mistake of trying to run backwards into the end zone and give up 2 more points.
Yeah, that wouldn't have been good.
But now we're at 6:15, and the game has completely changed. We've played this entire game down here on the South Fulton into the field in the fourth quarter.
Joiner in the gun. There's a snap.
Hello.
Oh, good gravy.
It's that
that's,
man
that's
again.
Gonna be close. That's going to be close.
Number 33, Torian Spencer from Langston.
Hold on now. Why are they spotting the ball right there?
Wow.
No.
Are
you gotta
kidding
be,
me?
You got to be – he ran backwards.
Wow.
That's oh, a horrible my spot. Goodness. Apparently there was a deal on the crack today. My goodness.
Wow.
My good gravy, man. That's a horrible spot. Here comes the pressure. Quick throw out to number 6. He's going to be close. Is that 6 or 8?
Number 8.
Thanks. That's Orlando Posey.
And that was a gain of 9, but it's going to bring up 4th down and 3.
Yeah, you got to punt this.
Yes, you do.
I cannot believe the spot, though. What play was that? Was that play 91?
Mm-mm.
That's – my goodness. That was horrendous. Because the kid turned and ran backwards. Now, he stopped and tried to turn around at, like, the 1-yard line.
Yeah.
But that's where the ball should have been. That was almost a safety, and they spotted it back at the 8.
Now we're coming with the 5th punt.
Man, there's the kick. That's a nice high punt.
He'll bounce back, though.
Good job right there fielding the ball by number 37 from Muscogee.
Ends up
John
being
a Tucker.
29-yard punt. And now South Fulton with 4:29 to go is going to start at their own 45.
I mean, you know, this is what you hope for when you're in an evenly matched game. This is what you hope for. You hope that you have a chance to get it done. And here's your opportunity. You know, to be down 14-0 at the start of the fourth quarter and to be able to come down and you know, now have a chance to tie it up. Dixon at quarterback trips to the field, Single receiver to the boundary. Anderson in the backfield. There's a snap. Looks screen. Like a screen. Anderson's out in space. He's got some help. He is churning.
Hello.
That guy, you know he reminds me of running like that? Do you remember Les Pullen?
I do.
Kind of previews our next game. Les was a really good running back at Riverdale way back when.
When he was beating us to death.
Yeah. This game right here has been super exciting. South Fulton versus Muscogee, but I expect nothing less than this for the Atlantic Public Schools versus Clayton County game, which will immediately follow this game.
Pretty good collection of athletes we got out here. You can't do that.
He was on the ball. That's illegal. He was on the ball.
And there's no flag.
Run by Dixon right there. He's going to be pretty close to a first down.
He got the first down.
Little extracurriculars right there. Let's come some of those defensive linemen kind of mixing it up for Muscogee. You know,
well, they've done in the second half to kind of add to kind of help out is they've ran the quarterback to give themselves an extra blocker.
Well, that's always a good idea if you have that luxury.
Well, these guys from South Fulton, these quarterbacks can all move.
There comes APS now running back to the back of the end zone. There's the motion from left to right. There it goes, and it's caught.
Number 13.
Ball caught by number 13. Trayvon Freeman from Creekside. Big throw and catch right there.
2:56, and it's a first down at the 20. So we're in the red zone, Coach, and
2:50 counting.
You couldn't have wanted more than this when you signed up to do it.
I tell you what, if Muscogee won, but, you know, this is here just like it is for South Fulton. It's there for Muscogee. Get a stop, and that's the game. There's a snap. Give on the jet.
Hey, guess who?
Yeah, bless America.
Guess who?
That's number 98, Devontae Fanning helping out his partner in crime there, Kevon Peterson.
Peterson was set the edge right there. That play was dead on arrival. Trust me.
My goodness, and it took, you know, what was it? First and 10 from the 20, now it's
– second and 18, baby, from the 28.
That hurts.
Mr. Peterson seems to show up when they need a play.
Indeed he does. I think I'll run to the left side of the offense. If I
got timeout right here.
Yeah, they're fixing to talk about that. Run away from 94.
Well, they've done a good job of neutralizing the defensive front in this half by adding the extra blocker. But if you're not going to have a tight end sit on that side and you're going to try to run jet, that's not a good plan.
Now you need some help over there. Should be. All right, that last play right there. You see the meeting at the quarterback. That whole left side of the defense, Devontae Fanning. And, golly, just – he even got held.
Yeah.
They even held Kevon Peterson, and it didn't matter. There was nothing they could do. That guy is a man among boys. Motion from right to left out of doubles.
Wheel route.
Quarterback looks. He lets it fly across the middle. He's got a man. He's in. Yes, sir. Touchdown, South Fulton.
28-yard touchdown pass right there.
I think that's number 11.
It is.
That'd be Devin Hall out of Westlake. I think some of these kids traded jerseys.
That's definitely not a Westlake helmet.
No, I don't know if they traded helmets, they traded jerseys. Yeah, if you've ever been part of an all-star game, the kids kind of do what they want in that respect. But that was a big-time play.
So now the all-important point after, Coach.
Well, you know, normally this is not a very big deal. But, you know, even in a game where there's pressure, you know, you still got to get a snap, a hold, and
And we're tied with a minute 51. Double post with a wheel route. That's.
And here we go. There's the motion coming across. You know, it's so funny. We watched this same thing happen a minute ago. The difference is that where they went outside with Muscogee, South Fulton came back to the middle. There he is, and there was decent coverage because you had two guys standing right there. But, you know, just like that, we got us a tie game.
Now you got to get this return. You can't have a return at the 9-yard line.
Well, the problem is you're not going to get a chance to return.
He dropped one at the half-yard line. So
I tell you what, if I could teach a kicker to do that every time.
We'd do it every time.
Drop it at the 1-yard line and let it bounce backwards. And there's the kick. It's up, and it's going to be brought out of the end zone by number
five. Yikes.
Ball brought out by number five, Caleb Bailey. Play made by, is that 94?
34,
thank you. 34, that's Rashad Wallace out of Langston Hughes.
With a Westlake helmet on.
Maybe I should stop talking about who the school is and just talk about what the player's name is. You know, right here, I'm looking for any kind of double move out of Mr. Vennessy. But despite the big D-line play, the offensive line gave some time on that last one.
Oh, yeah.
Because the quarterback was able to sit there and kind of survey the field and then come back. Joyner.
Uh-oh.
Sacked.
That is the first sack of the game for South Fulton.
I tell you what, South Fulton is fired up right now. They're feeling it. Feeling the flow. All good things. Doing the bull dance.
Working it.
Doubles for Muscogee. Joyner in the gun. There's a snap. He looks to his left, lets it fly.
Oh, wow.
And that could have been really bad.
Yes, it could have, Coach. That was.
That pass intended for Caleb Bailey, and Fleming broke on that, and I thought that he might get there. And if he does, it's 21-14 with a minute left.
So now, Coach, you got a minute and 11. You know.
Yeah.
South Fulton's got too many people on the field. No, they don't.
There's a snap. Joyner looking to his left, comes back to his right, lets it fly.
Incomplete.
And they're going to say that's incomplete, out of bounds. Now with a minute four.
They got a punt.
They have to punt from their own 12-yard line. The last time they got about a 30-yard punt, so now South Fulton, you know, gets the ball somewhere around the 42-yard line with a minute left.
Mm-hmm. And one timeout.
And one timeout, yeah. Actually, two timeouts?
No, one they called. Remember they called one?
Oh, yeah, they did call two.
Called one after the failed jet sweep attempt. Wow, this is – I mean, the way this game has just flip-flopped is amazing.
Xavier Clark back to kick. There's a snap.
They are holding that guy running down the field. Oh, low kick. He's going to get a return.
And Fleming.
Nice coverage.
Good job on the punt coverage right there.
That was a 31-yard punt and no return. So, here you go, Coach. 56 seconds right here.
I tell you what, if you ran that same look where you had the wheel come out and you had the post, what if the outside guy who was also running a post, what if he ran a dig?
He'd be wide open running up underneath everybody.
That's what I'm thinking.
My biggest fear right here as a play caller would be this. You know, everybody's fired up. Everybody's locked in. We're going to go win the game right here. And one of these man beasts that's playing on the defensive line gets free. Hit somebody from behind, the ball pops loose. And
somebody goes run down the
track. Yeah.
That's a scary thought.
That's one of those things.
Well, here's their chance. Empty look right here. Nobody else blocking.
Quarterback trap.
Oh.
Wow. Nostradamus says.
Caleb Dixon right there loses the handle on it, but is able to get it back.
With the ball being in South Fulton's hand this entire quarter, you're starting to see some tired people on that front.
Okay. Yeah, they just call timeout. South Fulton uses its final timeout.
30 seconds left.
But you let 18 seconds run off the clock. I'm not sure about that one.
All right.
I don't like to second-guess coaches. But I'm just saying, I don't know if you were if they were thinking about that one. But while we've got a second during this timeout, we'd like to thank the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia for putting on this great game, this Senior Bowl Classic. We know a lot of kids that play here, a lot of the coaches from both sides. It's just good to see kids get to come out here and get to showcase their talents. And, you know, as coaches, it's always fun to come out for them to coach one more game this year. And I thoroughly enjoy being here to watch it.
And the big thing about this, Coach, is that there are a lot of guys out here that are already, you know, walking around with offers in their back pocket. But there are a lot of guys out here that, you know, deserve the chance to play at the next level that could possibly, you know, gain an offer by playing in this game. So, you know, this is a big-time recruiting tool as well.
So, here we go. Empty look for South Fulton.
They've gone to the speed rushers on the edge right here.
Throw. It's kind of an aired throw. I think if he puts a little air under that and takes it down the sideline, he might have something.
I think what they were trying to do right there is see if they can get something quick and get out of bounds. You know, I'm not trying to make a suggestion, but if you work the middle of the field right here, I'm pretty sure if they can't rush the field goal guy, this guy can make a 50-yard field goal. He said in pregame anywhere inside the 30.
Well, there you go. That's definitely something you got to be thinking about. There's a snap. Dixon drops. Good protection.
He's wide open.
Good protection. Get up. Get the first down. Get out of bounds. Get out of bounds. Get out. He's
got to stop. But you got to bang it right here.
Stop, Ben. Stop, Ben. Stop, Ben.
Got the first down. But you got to do exactly what you say. You got to get up on the ball and spike it.
I tell you what, that was great protection right there by the South Fulton offensive line.
Get on the ball and spike it. Get up there and spike it as soon as he met.
That's what he's signaling to everybody right now.
All right, so 4 seconds run off the clock right there on that spike.
That's a long spike, buddy.
All right, so here's the thing. Something to the middle of the field is pretty much out right here, unless you're going to score.
I tell you, you know what I might would have done there?
Here it comes. 51-yard field goal.
I think that I would have gone ahead and planned this and put in the fake spike. The old Dan Marino. Act like you're going to spike it and then pump it and go to the end zone.
All right, so we're going to
make
it a 48-yard field goal.
There's no rush, but that's a boot right there.
Oh.
What's the penalty? Oh, no.
Delay.
Are they saying it was to delay a game?
Oh, they didn't call it.
Okay.
So here we go. We're going to line up and kick this game-winning field goal attempt, Coach.
All right, there's a snap. Hold.
Uh-oh. No good.
Man, that was close. I had the distance. What was that, just wide right? Well, looks like we're going to overtime, folks.
They said there's 9 seconds left. Nobody started the clock. The clock only ran 1 second off.
Well, it was a really fast kick.
Yes, that is the truth.
Don't forget to stay tuned. Stay with us for the Atlanta Public Schools versus Clayton County game, which is coming up right after this one. Should be quite a game as well. really good evenly matched game so far this game, obviously.
You don't say, huh?
Yeah. For those of you that can't compare numbers.
Yeah, the ball doesn't – you don't get to start up there, big guy. You got to go where there's – it's a field goal attempt. It goes back to the 20.
Yeah, it's high school rules. So there it is. Everybody seems to be confused about it. Must not be a lot of field goals kicked in Muscogee County.
Not everybody has a four-star kicker like we do, Coach. Well,
so you get lucky sometimes. All right, here we go. Trip set for Muscogee.
I cannot believe they're throwing the ball.
Joyner drops. Looking across the middle. That ball dropped. Pass intended for number 22, Corey Calhoun. And it wasn't defended. It was just dropped.
I think they were getting ready to start the lateral game. I don't know why you do that in a tie game unless it's going to end in a tie.
Well, I didn't ask about overtime before the game started. And I guess we'll find out shortly if there is going to be overtime. Although it's not a region game. quick give right there around the left side. He gets the edge. He's fighting for everything he's worth. Nice carry right there by Fred Davis from Muscogee. Brought down by a host of South Fultonites.
South Fultonites.
Well, you think about, calling the team name.
Let's see, we got Coach Silveri coming out to the middle of the field right here. Find out if we're going to play some overtime or not.
So, we're waiting to see here. Now, I know in the past they've done overtime.
It looks like they're going to do it because here comes the coin flip.
There we go. For those of you who don't know the rules for high school overtime, both team gets the ball on the 15. Is that correct?
I think that's right. I think you can get one first down.
You can get one first down. After the second OT, you have to go for two, if I'm not mistaken.
That is correct.
So.
It is an abbreviated form of the college overtime. Whereas in college, you get it at the 25.
There's the toss. Looks like South Fulton has won the toss. I would imagine they're going to elect to go on defense first.
I would.
And looks like Muscogee wants to go into that. Which direction is that, Coach Chapman?
That would be east.
Wants to go into the east end zone. And those gentlemen shake hands and fixing to go to it right here.
We'll play a little overtime football on playoff Saturday.
Here we go. So, you folks that are watching are in for an extra bargain right here. I will tell you, I wasn't counting on overtime when it was 14-0 with 8 minutes left.
Nope.
But all-star games are a funny, funny thing. I will say that pass where it looks like the quarterback read stop and the receiver read go.
Yep. I'm sure that there's a lot of people on the sideline over there wishing that they would have just ran the ball and punted right now.
I'm sure I imagine what happened is the receiver heard fade and the quarterback heard fade stop. And one of them was wrong.
And we will never know who.
The poor quarterback, even if it was a fade stop, he's the one that gets blamed. Well.
I was about to say, we got too many people on the field.
Yeah, they get him off in time. Here comes motion from left to right from Muscogee. Looks down the middle.
He's wide open.
And could not get it to him. Could not get it. Joyner couldn't get it to who was that, number six?
Mm-hmm.
Joyner couldn't get it to Fred Davis. And the ball was almost picked right there by number eight, Jamil Williams. That was
That would have ended it quickly. Because then I come out and just kick the ball.
Especially with what the guy did just then. He, you know.
He was, I mean, he had the leg for it. Just
here comes same formation where they ran the smash concept.
That inverted nasty look. Joyner looking out to his left, has a man.
Intercepted. Number one.
And that's Fleming with the pick. You know, his coaches said, this is a guy to watch.
Yes, they did.
And
going to East Carolina.
When the game is on the line, you got to know where to go. So, it'll be interesting to see if South Fulton just, like, runs the ball a couple times, centers it up.
Tries to kick the game-winning field goal.
Or if they're actually going to take some shots at the end zone.
They're going to kick the game-winning field goal right now, Coach.
I don't blame you. Because, you know, the thing is if it's, something goes wrong, cover the ball up and do it again.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. What number is that kicker right there? Fixing to get a delay. All right. Fleming to hold. There's a snap.
They blocked it.
They didn't rush. He didn't get the ball up enough. He hit the ball too high. For those of you unfamiliar with kicking the ball, if you strike the ball from the center up, what happens is you get a driving kick that kind of stays, has a kind of a low trajectory. Whereas if you come underneath the ball, you don't get the distance, but you get nice lift.
Now, here's the thing. Muscogee County still has to play defense because it switches back and forth. So we're just in the second overtime period now.
Do we flip sides?
I wouldn't flip sides.
Yeah, if I'm a referee, I'm like, okay, it's going to waste time to flip sides. We're going to play. What's it's hard to do a player of the game when the game's still going. You know what I'm saying?
Especially right now when somebody may make a play in this overtime period where, you know, they become the player of the game.
You know, if they hit the field goal right there, yeah, but what have you done for me lately? You know what I'm saying? That's America, Jack. All right, here we go. Doubles look for South Fulton. Caleb Dixon in the gun. There's a snap. Quick give up the gut. He's got some room.
Wow.
And he just fell down. If he stays up right there.
Yep.
Who was that carrying that ball?
And they got spun around. Gain of 11 right there.
Number 27 on the carry right there. That's going to be Emmanuel McQueen. Nicely done.
So now you got first and goal. This is one of those things where, you know, you got three downs to get it in, then you're going to have to make that decision. Here comes the eye. They're going to call delay again.
How can that be delay? Did that not seem quick to you?
It did. Wow.
That seemed really fast.
I mean, unbelievable, but we've seen it all day.
Right. I just didn't think that much time had elapsed. I formation, slot left.
Here comes everybody. Center.
Play action. Golly.
Our boys again.
That's number 41 on the play right there from Muscogee.
41 bats DeMarcus, the ball down.
DeMarcus Hood bats it down, but that D-line is just bearing down on I can't remember the kid's name now.
He can't either.
That's Caleb Dixon. Yeah. Yeah. That's one of those where you jog the line sideline. They're like, "What's wrong? I got Dane Bramage. My head just bounced off the ground."
I tell you what, they can't. When they try to do straight dropbacks, especially from under center, there's not a chance to block the interior guys.
Play action, you got no shot. Motion from left to right.
Here comes the corner.
Dixon tries to let it fly on the slant, and he's in there. Anybody get a number on that one? That pass caught by number 4, Zachary Becton.
Nice throw right there.
I was about to say nicely done. So, I need to get the extra point team out there.
Yeah, heaven forbid we have another delay of game.
I think we're in route for one right now.
Are they going for two?
Okay, timeout.
Come on, coach.
Timeout. Timeout. There's no way you get this off. Timeout.
There it is.
Oh, my goodness. And for those of you that don't know, you get a timeout in each overtime period. I understand wanting to save your timeout for defense. I get that. However, when you decided you're going to go for two, you can't take a delay.
So I wonder if they told them you can't kick it in the second overtime.
Well, that's probably a good point. That would explain. But it seems like if there was that confusion, quarterback rolls to his right. Good almighty. He just got sandwiched.
And that's our boy again, Peterson.
Yep. Kevontae Peterson. Kevon, sorry. All right.
If we had a stats for sacks and pressures, we wouldn't have enough room to put it on the play sheet.
No, they've been just breathing down their neck the whole time.
And so now it's 20-14, and Muscogee County, who has done absolutely nothing on offense since 2 minutes to go in the third quarter, has now got to pull themselves up and score right here, or it's going to be a very disappointing trip back south for those gentlemen.
This is one of those where this game would keep me up at night.
Yes, they're not covering the slot.
There's a snap, and they give it. You pull that ball and throw it to that guy that would have been all by himself walking into the end zone.
Yep. Gain of 4, though, so you kept yourself ahead of the sticks right here.
Who was that that's by himself out there? Is that number 8?
Yes.
Orlando Posey is, going, I was going to walk into the end zone.
Yep, just give it to me.
Just throw me the ball.
And they still aren't covering the slot up there. I guess they bumped that guy out at the edge of the box.
Yeah.
And there it is. Man, inside zone.
First down. That carry by number 6, Fred Davis.
Here we go.
Man. Muscogee on the march. Yikes. It's going to be a loss of what, 2?
2.
Nice play by the interior of South Fulton right there.
Now, somewhere, somehow, number 10's got to show up right here.
Mr. Vennessy.
Please. He needs to be singled up and see if they want to cover him with one person. Maybe give a token fake.
There you go. Trips to the boundary. Here comes the slant to Mr. Vennessy.
No, they got a safety robbing it. Run it.
And Mr. Joyner's going to get in.
Wow. He almost didn't get in.
No, but he started high-stepping a little early on that one.
If that would have been the game last night, they'd have thrown a flag and backed him up 15 yards.
Well, here we go.
Well, I guess you can.
Here's the game.
Timeout.
They're going to talk about it.
Yes.
It's not a bad idea.
Here comes Philly special.
I definitely – All right. Here you have it right here. Just to give up the gut right there. He doesn't go down. I guess we're setting up the last touchdown.
No, I didn't hit record.
Okay. Hey, folks. We got kind of engrossed in the game here. So we missed out on that last touchdown, but we'll be happy to tell you all about it.
What happened was everybody was worried about number 10.
Yeah.
And then they ran the back out in the flat. So you
Fantasy runs a slant. They swing the back. And so everybody's concerned with the two of them. The back goes ahead and floats into the end zone like a wheel. And Mr. Joyner just walks in.
Yeah, because they had people making sure number 10 was not about to touch the football.
And so here we go. You got a doubles look, like a little stack. Okay, they're going to try to get Venice out over here on the left side. No, they bring him in motion.
It's the wheel route.
From left to right. Quarterback drops, looks, throws, and that ball is trapped. It's 20-20. Third overtime. Here we go, folks.
Muscogee County will be right back on offense.
All right. Here we go. Sometimes you have one of those games that's so exciting it will not end.
It just goes on and on and on.
Yep.
All right, so Muscogee County is back at the 15-yard line.
Hey, don't forget, right after this game here between South Fulton and Muscogee County, the Atlanta Public Schools versus Clayton County game will begin. Both teams getting the longest stretching period in the history of the world because they both came out with about 5 minutes left in the fourth quarter thinking they were going to need to be coming on out pretty soon to warm up. Little did they know. They were going to be part of an all-time record high school game.
There it is.
But it's been a great day here at the Minority Coaches Association of Georgia Senior Bowl Classic. Already an amazing day going into our third overtime here with Muscogee County versus South Fulton. Motion from left to right, the give on the zone up the gut off the jet. Picked up what looks to be about 4 yards. That carry by Fred Davis.
Going back to the spread look right here.
Here comes our Orlando. I wonder if they're going to cover him this time.
Got people running in and out of this thing like it's Walmart before Christmas.
The trips. Set to the right side. Joyner drops.
Whip route. Oh, nice play.
Oh, big time play. Ball deflected right there by number 34.
Yeah, I think so.
That's what I'm rolling with anyway.
Rashad Wallace.
Rashad Wallace. Because the whip route was there, and Mr. Venice is rather elusive. So
now you got to figure some things out right here. You got third down and about seven. You know, kicking game probably is not your strongest point.
No.
And this is a pretty big moment in the game.
There's a snap. Joyner drops. He decides to take off.
Oh. First down.
Did he get it?
I think so.
He's close.
They're going to give it to him.
Okay. That's a first down, Muscogee County. Good job by Mr. Joyner right there getting what he could get.
7 yard gain.
You know, that's just a heads-up play.
Right now, they're worried about somebody catching a touchdown. They're forgetting the guy with the ball.
Who's also quite a pretty good athlete.
Yeah, he's done a nice job of orchestrating this thing.
Doubles. There's a snap.
Touchdown.
Give right up the gut.
And that was – uh-oh.
Okay.
And now we have a penalty. I don't know what this penalty, who it's going to be on.
There's another one.
This is not going to be good.
Muscogee County gets in. That was Fred Davis on the carry who just plowed his way into the end zone. I'm not sure who the penalty was on. It's kind of hard to see. It was kind of a jumble of folks down in there.
The bad part about this is if it's on Muscogee County, you're fixing to have a 2-point conversion drive from the, you know, 18.
It is a touchdown. I think with the two flags, I think it's probably going to be offsetting.
Let's hope.
But it's such a shame if you're Muscogee County, if it was on South Fulton.
You'd be going from the 1 yard line right here.
Well, how does the overtime work? Could you not take it on the try?
That's what I'm saying. You know, you could choose to back them up, make them start at the 30.
That would be brutal.
And dirty.
I'm not sure about that. If we could have someone from rules check on that.
On it.
Let's make a decision down there, fellas.
Yes, you got to love the referee powwow. That's how I know I'm fixing to get screwed when they're all circled up. And I mean that in the nicest way possible.
So what they call offsetting?
I think so.
Now, here's my thing, Coach. I'm as bad as any other OC in the world when it gets down to this. You got to think you got to make up something to get these 3 yards, right? What did you just do?
I give it to Fred Davis again.
Fred Davis just ran through people and took their soul into the end zone with him. So, you know, it might be something that I would think about. Oh, they did that, Coach. They called the personal foul on South Fulton, and they told them they're going to take it on the series. So they're going to start at the 30.
No.
They just did. That's the referee. There's Fred Davis.
There's Fred Davis, who lowers his shoulder, runs behind his pads, and gets in the end zone. And that was a huge two-point conversion right there. So
now they'll start at the 30. He just told the referee.
This is our fourth overtime, if I'm not mistaken.
It is.
So – at the bottom half of the fourth overtime, it is Muscogee County 28, South Fulton 20. And I think we are correct that they took it after the try.
No, dude. You can't back it up twice, can you?
Two personal fouls.
Wow.
Jeez, Louise. That is a – dagger in the heart.
Somebody told this guy, make the game over.
Now, the good news
is – they can get first downs.
You can get first downs, but you've got to put together a drive now.
Yep.
You've got to put together a 45-yard drive as opposed to a 15-yard drive.
And here comes a trick play.
For those of you at home doing the math, that's three times.
This is a trick play. This is a trick play, Coach.
Bunch right. Caleb Dixon in the gun. Anderson back there with him. Lots of conversation. That's never confidence inspiring.
No, just toss.
Toss to the right side.
Bunch crunch.
My goodness. He's run down by Devontae Fanning. That kid is fast.
Golly, man. I'm telling you right now, there's going to be some people needing an ice bath at the end of this game.
This D-line, buddy. Coach Baker from Muscogee County was
not lying.
He was 100% accurate.
He told the truth.
All right, doubles look for South Fulton. Dixon waiting on a snap. He's in the gun. Anderson standing next to him. There's a snap. He drops. Lots of pressure.
And intercepted. They called it incomplete. Yep, it should be. Everybody off on the sideline, ran on the field. That could be a penalty.
Well, there are some things you shouldn't throw a penalty on. Now, if I were on the South Fulton sideline, I'd be like, their whole team's out there.
Yep, I would be too. Third down right here, though.
If I'm on the Muscogee sideline, I'm going, come on, man, their kids are celebrating. Perspective.
It is. They're still trying. He's still trying to argue his point down here that he got his feet down.
Here comes Anthony Bonner playing. He's at left defensive end.
Oh, my word.
And he runs a 4.46 40 coming off the edge. And he is lined up wide.
He's in an 18. That's 2.9 techniques.
Dixon is by himself in the empty. Nice job right there by the left tackle. Nice pickup. Good D right there.
All right, so we got fourth down and 9.
That's one of those where I'm like, man, we got to get the first down.
Yeah, I'm thinking that maybe that was lost on with all the penalties. I think that may have been a point that was that they forgot about. You can still get a first down.
It's one of those things that, you know, the kids see something downfield, and you're like, man, get the first down.
Mm-hmm. So, we got 4th and 9 right here.
All right. I'm expecting some sort of stunt up front.
I am. I'm thinking right there, the nose and the guard, a little, you know, ego. There it is.
Yep.
There's a hold, big as all day, and there's a pick.
He
caught it, but he was out of bounds. So that's the end of it, Coach. That's the game.
And there it is, folks. I tell you what now, that was a great game. 4 overtimes.
Mr. Peterson was about to have sack number 5 because if he didn't get held right there, he basically got tackled, bear hugged to the ground.
That was a great job by both teams to stick it out to the very end. That was a gutsy performance by both groups. Now, if it's me, you know.
If it's you, what? What are we doing, player of the game
right now?
Normally player of the game, you know, you had Vennessee who had 2 touchdowns.
Right. Yes.
You had Fred Davis who came up big at the end of the game.
Yes.
I still say Kevon Peterson is my player of the game.
Mine too.
And so.
What number was Kevon?
94.
Okay, that was something you could have handed me at 5-minute mark, Dan. Mister, I was waiting for something. You could have at least gave me something. But congratulations, Kevon, for being the Score Sports player of the game, number 94. What school was he from?
Hardaway.
With the head coach running that. That was a great game overall, 28-20. 3 or 4 overtimes. I counted 3, but y'all said 4. I'm going to go with y'all on the 4 overtimes. Coming up next, we will be ending this program. You'll have to go back on YouTube to search for the same game itself. Glad to have everybody with us tuning in today. We had some wonderful comments throughout it on YouTube. I'm glad you're tuning in and chiming in. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thank you again, Minority Coaches Association of Georgia, for most importantly saying, hey, let's take these 4 counties and let's play them together. Let's see what happens. This next matchup is going to be great. But we once again, congratulations to Muscogee. Congratulations for both teams in South Fulton coming out here fighting through. You know, this is New Year's weekend, and they said, hey, we're going to play this game. And this is some of these players' last football game in general. They might not make it to the next level. Those that do, we wish them the best of luck. Happy New Year's to everybody. Be safe. Take care of yourselves. We'll see you soon. We'll go live here in roughly about 30 minutes. Take care.